Today in Norman, Oklahoma, Sooners all-time touchdown passing leader Landry Jones duels with the nation's leader in total offense, Nick Florence of the Baylor Bears. A Big 12 showdown right now on Fox College Football. Welcome to Gaylord Family Memorial Stadium in Norman, Oklahoma for Fox College Football. Today, a Big 12 matchup between the Baylor Bears and the number 12 Oklahoma Sooners. Hi, everybody. I'm Steve Fizziak. When this season began, Oklahoma quarterback Landry Jones was working with only one experienced wide receiver, Kenny Stills. First four games, they only averaged 258 yards through the air. But the last four games, the newcomers are getting together with Landry Jones, and he has averaged 345 yards passing per game. Well, joining me this afternoon is J.C. Pearson, who knows a little bit about defending wide receivers. He was a former defensive back. What is it like when a quarterback and a wide receiver are on the same page?
Well, it brings back a lot of bad memories for an old defensive back like me, but it's great for OU because Landry Jones seems to be on page with all of his wide receivers now. You can just see the comfort and the confidence and the trust that he has that these guys are going to be where they're supposed to be now. So he's throwing the ball with the anticipation even before they get out of their break. Landry Jones has said that the last four games has probably been the best stretch of his career, throwing for over 300 yards a game. And obviously it's because he and this talented wide receiving core are now on the same page.
Baylor loves to pass as well. They're the number one passing offense in the nation, and yet their running game is what everybody was talking about last week.
Well, they finally got some balance and some production out of their running game last week. Glasgow Martin and Lake Seastrunk both ran for over 100 yards against KU. They're calling themselves Thunder and Lightning now. We all know that Baylor can throw the football, but I think for them to have success today, they're going to have to get these two guys going again in the run game.
This is game number 22 between Baylor and Oklahoma. The Sooners have won all but one, but that loss came last year when RG3 and the Bears won by 7. The Sooners looking for revenge in Norman today. Fox College Football is presented by Frost Brute Coors Light, the game's most refreshing beer, and by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price every day. An F-16 flyover celebrating Monday's Veterans Day here in Norman, Oklahoma. Let's check in with the third member of our team, Laura McKeeman.
When the 2012 season started, the receiver position was perceived as an area of weakness for the Sooners. But now, thanks to the transfers of Justin Brown and Jalen Saunders, it's an area of strength. Bob Stoops knew he would need leadership on and off the field from Justin Brown, and he's gotten that. Brown has also proved himself as a solid target for Landry Jones offensively. And he's taken some of the weight off Kenny Still's shoulders on special teams. Steve and J.C., Brown's size and vision makes him such a weapon on punt return.
No question about it. He had that 90-yard punt return for a touchdown against the Kansas Jayhawks earlier this year. And we do have some fierce winds whipping up to 26 miles an hour out of the south. But because they're coming from the south, the temperature is a comfortable 73 degrees here in the middle of November. So they'll have to hold the football for Aaron Jones as Baylor won the coin toss and elected to defer to the second half. Oklahoma will receive. Jones with the kickoff. Back deep, number 22, Roy Finch, number 24, Brennan Clay. And because he has that southern wind behind him, he kicks it out of the end zone. And here is the All-American candidate, Landry Jones. He's thrown for over 2,400 yards this year, 16 touchdowns, but we told you, on the same page, last four games, very well.
Yeah, really playing well and moving well in the pocket. That's one of the things that he wants to do better, is move in the pocket and still be able to deliver the ball down the field. But Landry Jones has been on fire the last four games.
Right now they will go with a fullback in Trey Millard and Damian Williams, who was questionable because of an ankle injury. They swing it off to Trey Millard, and he has a good gain up past the 35-yard line. First down for Oklahoma, got a gain of 13. Sam Hull with the tackle. Oklahoma, much like Baylor, likes to hurry it up, and Jones swings it to the left, perfectly thrown. Another first down out near midfield. Ahmad Dixon on the tackle of Jalen Saunders.
And that shows you the strong arm of Landry Jones to be able to throw that ball from the far hash to the sideline to Jalen Saunders. It's a big throw.
Now play action pass, and they swing it back to the right side to Saunders, who had that huge game against Notre Dame with 15 catches, 8 in the first quarter, and he already has 2 on this drive.
Yeah, and you see the tempo that Oklahoma's coming out playing at, playing fast and attacking this Baylor defense that has struggled all year long. The 120th ranked defense in the country, which is dead last. Oklahoma comes out quickly and attacks down the field.
And Jones will go with a heavy look in the backfield with 2 fullbacks in Millard and Ripkowski.
This is typically their running formation.
They do run Damian Williams, who has a healthy gain inside the 35-yard line. And JC, how about your keys to the game?
Well, for Oklahoma, just offensively, they just need to use all of their weapons, spread the wealth around like they've been doing, and then defensively, they've got to take care of Terrence Williams, the leading receiver in the country. They have to make sure that they limit his yards and catches.
We do have an injured Baylor Bear on the field. And we'll take a timeout here, fans, and be right back as Oklahoma with their first drive. On the very first drive, Baylor's defensive linebacker Rodney Chadwick, a senior, is injured, taken off the field, and he is out of Carthage, Texas. Let's see how he got hurt.
Yeah, and here he is right there, number 26, and you can see just trying to fight off a block. Just inadvertently, looks like Adam Shedd, number 74, just rolled him up and rolled up that right knee. Now he's replaced by Hager, Bryce Hager, who was the starter at inside linebacker up until a few weeks ago. And you can see right there, third in the Big 12 in tackles per game. When they made that switch to Chadwick, Hager was actually leading the Big 12 in tackles, but they felt like Chadwick was a more athletic guy and was going to give him a little bit more intensity. So let's see, keep an eye on Hager.
We just saw how you can get a quick timeout and rest for your players. A cheerleader just lets go of a pom-pom and lets it, the wind take care of it onto the field. But Jones has been hot on this first drive, 3 for 3 for 36 yards. He will run the football, and Williams not much there. This time straightened up by Gary Mason, a defensive tackle, and Chris McAllister. Hager was also helping out, the new middle linebacker.
Third down has been a problem for Baylor's defense all year, Steve. I mean, one of the worst in the country, or the worst in the country, 58%. Teams have been able to convert on third down, so they haven't been able to get off the field. They've hurt themselves.
They were much better last week in their victory over the Kansas Jayhawks, 41-14, particularly in the second half when they shut out the Jayhawks. Our official is Reggie Smith, the lead referee.
Illegal substitution, 12 in the formation, defense. That's a 5-yard penalty and yields a first down.
Well, that's one way to convert from third down to first.
And there again, Baylor not giving themselves a chance defensively. You know, the thing for them is they've got to find a way to get off the football field. You know, they played too many plays 2 weeks ago when we had them against Iowa State. A lot of the same issues on third down, and Iowa State ended up running 102 plays against this defense and just completely wore them down. Can't do that against Oklahoma.
Now from the 26-yard line, Jones will run it. And this first time as Millard, who came in with 128 yards rushing and averaging 6.5 yards per carry. Their run game, it seems like they have so many rushers over 6 yards per carry. Millard, 6.4. Damian Williams, 6.5. Dominique Whaley, 6.2. And Brennan Clay, who had that 157 yard game last week against Iowa State, he's averaging almost 7 yards per carry.
Single coverage at the top of the screen.
Jones looking that way, fires it. He had Kenny Stills wide open at the 8 yard line, or the 13 yard line, I beg your pardon, but Stills turned his head early.
Yeah, just a drop. Don't know if the wind might have played a factor, but the ball was there on time and on the money. Kenny Stills just drops the ball. Not going to see that happen too many times.
This is where Baylor must work well. It's third down and long. They're showing blitz. Jones changing up, heavy look to the left side. And he swings it to the inside receiver. That is Kenny Stills, who gets the first down. Stills to the 10-yard line. Our Academy Sports and Outdoors Right Stuff player for Oklahoma is Kenny Stills. 6 catches, 92 yards, including 2 important touchdowns.
You can see the confidence that Landry has in him. He has a drop on one play, comes right back to him on third down to convert for the first down.
Well, this is their third year working together, and here is the run to Brennan Clay, who had the huge game last week. Short gain here. Nick Johnson on the tackle.
Again, they use their running game. They're not a powerful smash mouth running football team, but they use their running game to really set up the play action passes. And when they do run, they're an inside zone running team or an outside zone running team where they can just get a man on a man up front and just let their talented running backs find a crease or a seam and get down the field.
This is the 10th play of this drive. Brennan Clay near the 5 yard line, then pushed back by Bryce Hager, who came in for the injured Rodney Chadwick. Of course, there's the great Bob Stoops in his 14th year at Oklahoma, 145 victories, and that is tied, of course, with the great Bud Wilkinson for second place all time in Oklahoma history. Barry Switzer has the most. It is third and goal from the 5. He has his running back wide open for the catch, Brennan Clay, and the touchdown.
They isolate the linebacker, Eddie Lackey. Baylor's going to come in and play a lot of man coverage, but you've got to be able to match up, and with all of these weapons that OU has, it's tough. And that time they get Brennan Clay matched up on a linebacker, he just beats him to the outside, just a mismatch in coverage.
Michael Honeycutt for the point after touchdown. We were talking with members of the media before the ball game, and they said Jones last week against Iowa State, it was like throwing darts, and this one was perfectly thrown to Brennan Clay, his first receiving touchdown this season. Brennan Clay, a fine running back for the Oklahoma Sooners. The one thing you noted before was the fact they have so many weapons.
Yeah, and Baylor plays a lot of man-to-man, but watch Eddie Lackey. Just circle him there. If you have man, you got to go get him right now. He gets caught just staring down the quarterback, and now Brennan Clay is able to get outside of him, out-leverage him, and then get to the corner for an easy throw and a touchdown. When you have man coverage, that is your responsibility only. Can't get caught staring down the quarterback.
And Jones was practically perfect, 5 for 6 on that drive. The only incompletion was the pass that Kenny Stills dropped that was right in his hands. That is our BMW look. And Landry Jones takes a seat. Not sure if that football is going to stay on that tee with the wind blowing at 25 miles an hour. It is Patrick O'Hara to kick off, not Michael Honeycliff.
Yeah, and with the wind blowing so hard, I'm surprised that Oklahoma was able to throw the ball so efficiently. Other than that one drop, like you said, they were perfect going down the field. But this wind will play a factor at some point in this game.
The kick into the teeth of a wind, but it is a good one, and they will go to one knee. Darryl Stoneham, and that means it'll be Baylor football for the first time. And they have a very talented senior quarterback, Nick Florence, who is number one in the nation in total offense, also number one, we told you, in passing. There he is at 64%, but over 3,000 yards this year and 25 touchdowns.
Those are big numbers. This offense, when they get rolling, they are tough to stop. They really spread the field and isolate defenders one-on-one. So they've got to make a lot of plays in space. And you can see how far across the field all those white jerseys are spread out.
Lake Seastrunk gets the start. Instead, they will run a reverse. And a good gain out past the 30-yard line for about 5 yards before Javon Harris takes out Terrence Williams, who is the star of the Baylor offense. Our Academy Sports and Outdoors right-stuff player for Baylor is Terrence Williams, leading the nation in receiving yards. Florence dumps it off, and that almost was a lateral. I almost thought that was behind Lake Seastrunk. We saw him at his best. He was a little slow at the beginning of the season, understanding what they wanted to do. But he had some wow moments last week, both rushing and receiving.
Really feeling more comfortable in his offense as he learns it and as they learn him. The transfer from Oregon, 4-3, 40 guy, a lot of speed, a lot of quickness. They want to make sure they get him a lot of touches today at around 20 or so.
Glasgow Martin is the lone back. Florence will wing it to the right side. It's almost picked off. And that would have been a pick six, but Javon Harris just unloaded on Goodley. There is a flag down.
Tell you, that ball was very, very nearly intercepted. Then as it was bouncing around, Harris had got a big shot down there. I think that's what they called, but I don't know if that ball was still bouncing around and in play.
Personal foul, get on the defenseless receiver. Defense, a 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
It's Javon Harris right there. Let's see if he goes to the head. And this is a game for Javon Harris that's personal, because he got beaten last year against Baylor a number of times and gave up the game-winning touchdown. Game for him.
Well, Robert Griffin III burned a lot of very talented defensive backs last year, winning that Heisman Trophy. Now Florence looking deep. He swings it left. We would like to welcome those who are watching the Kansas-Texas Tech game. Steve Fiziak here with J.C. Pearson and Laura McKeeman. And what a game, as Kansas barely lost in two overtimes to Texas Tech, 41-34.
Defense, number two. Spot of the foul, automatic first down.
Meantime, Julian Wilson with the interference. And twice now, penalties have resulted in Baylor first downs, and that has to concern Bob Stoops. His defense, number one in the Big 12 Conference in scoring and total and pass defense. Florence swinging it deep. Incomplete, intended for Lanier Sampson.
Well, this Oklahoma defense, like you were saying, number one in the Big 12, they play a lot of man-to-man coverage. And they're going to try to get pressure on Nick Florence. But at the same time, when you play a lot of man coverage, you're also susceptible to getting beaten down the field. So it's going to be a good matchup with this secondary and these wide receivers of Baylor.
Lawrence with time dumps it off. That's the second drop by a running back. Glasgow Martin had it in his hands and would have had at least 5, perhaps 10 yards in the first down. Instead, it's 3rd and 10. And now the Sooners can pin their ears back and go after Florence.
Yeah, you got to make those plays. And Glasgow Martin is a guy that can catch the ball, but they don't really throw to their running backs a lot. Salubi is their leading receiver out of the backfield. He only has 8 catches on the year, so those guys aren't used to catching the ball.
Oklahoma showing blitz from the right side, and Aaron Franklin, he's number 25, and here he comes. Florence unloads. It is caught by Terrence Williams, but well shy of a first down as he was battling with the defensive back, DeMontre Hurst.
DeMontre Hurst gets a great break on this ball. Watch number 6 at the top of the screen, gets a great break on the curl and actually should come up with the interception, but he knows that he can jump those short to intermediate routes because he had a safety behind him over the top.
Baylor going for it on 4th down, but they're taking their time, and you wonder if they'll take a flag here as the clock winds down and then go ahead and punt the football. Well, we'll see.
A lot of confusion.
And finally, they call timeout.
Timeout, Baylor.
Well, Art Briles knows his team is within 2 wins of becoming bowl eligible, and he will take an upset along the way to do that. Can they beat Oklahoma and Landry Jones, one of the top quarterbacks in the nation, who already has thrown for 1 touchdown, giving his Sooners a 7-0 lead? Art Briles has changed his mind after the timeout. He was going to go for it on 4th down. Instead, with a 25-mile-an-hour wind behind his kicker, Aaron Jones, he is going to let him try from the right hash mark a 57-yard field goal. His season long is 44. His career long is 50. Jones, out of the state of Texas. And it is good. How about that from Aaron Jones? They're ruling at 58 yards.
Great kick by that young man. Helps to have a 26-mile-an-hour wind.
You got that right. He hammered it from 58. Jones with his career best in Norman, Oklahoma. 7-3, Sooners lead Baylor. Oklahoma leads Baylor 7-3. They went right down the field on their first drive, JC.
They sure did. Very impressive. Landry Jones, 5 of 6 passing the ball. Starts out here with the short boot pass to Millard out of the backfield, and then started to go down the field here to Jalen Saunders. Again finds Jalen Saunders working the middle of the field, and then comes back on a big 3rd down to Kenny Stills that converts to a 1st down. And then how about the touchdown, the swing pass to Brennan Clay. Very impressive drive by the Oklahoma Sooners.
1 drop on that entire drive, and it was Kenny Stills, who knows a lot about football. His father played in the NFL, so they worked out in the backyard quite often, and he told me his son never dropped a pass.
Yeah, the problem, his father was a defensive back, though, and you know what they say about defensive backs, wide receivers, they can't catch.
So they go to the secondary.
So the problem is he was learning from a defensive back. No, we're just kidding. Grew up with Kenny Stills. We go way back, a good friend of mine.
And he is off to your right, so.
And he still can't
giving
catch.
Him a hard time. And as JC said, he still can't catch. Here is Aaron Jones with the kickoff. Just blasted one 58 yards, the 3rd longest field goal in Baylor history. Baylor is going to have to play without Rodney Chadwick, who hurt his knee on this play. For more on the injury, let's go to Laura.
Steve, sad day for Rodney Chadwick, who is a senior, and I have confirmation from the Baylor athletic crew that he will not be playing for the rest of the year. His season is done due to this right knee sprain. Sad for him. Bryce Hager, a leader on this defense, came over and gave him a long emotional hug, Steve.
Thank you very much, Laura. And that's a shame because the senior from Carthage, Texas, started every single game last year on the run. Very short game for Oklahoma as they run Sterling Shepard. And there's Nick Florence, his quarterback, coming over.
It's always unfortunate when a player on your team goes down, but a senior, you know that his season is over. But it's great to see that his teammates are coming over and, you know, telling him to hang in there.
Second down and 7 for Oklahoma on that first drive. Baylor got very little pressure on Landry Jones. That time the pass was dropped, and what a hit by Eddie Lackey, and then a flag for apparently the late hit. Maybe it was helmet to helmet.
Yeah, on a defenseless receiver again. We saw that earlier where the Oklahoma player got called for that.
Personal foul, targeting defense number 5. A 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
The Eddie Lackey just comes out, and he doesn't lead with his head. He hits with his shoulder. You know, to me, being a defensive player, that's a clean play. Now, obviously, they want to try to, for the safety of the game, they want to try to protect it, but that's tough because the ball is still in the air. You don't know if that receiver's actually caught it or not. It's just a tough bang-bang play.
Yeah, if the athlete catches the football, it's absolutely clean. And here is a good run by Brennan Clay coming out of the backfield. A gain of about 5-6 yards as Mike Hicks and Ahmad Dixon combined for the stop.
You know what Baylor's got to do defensively, Steve, is they've got to be aggressive. They can't just line up and stop Oklahoma.
This time, Baylor is relentless in their pursuit as they try and run wide, but Gary Mason, it would not be denied. He's the senior from the state of Texas, his fifth-year senior. Started the last 2 years.
Yeah, and they've got to move up front. They've got to slant. They've got to get in some gaps. And they've got to be a little unpredictable and try to make Landry just think when he throws the ball and try to allow that pressure some time to get there.
The two inside receivers are Jalen Saunders in the right and Sterling Shepard on the left. Jones wings it. First down, 45-yard line. Kenny Stills.
That time Baylor just comes with a 3-man rush, so you get no pressure on Landry Jones, and you can't just let him get comfortable in the pocket. Not with all of these weapons and receivers around him, somebody's going to get open down the field. And, you know, that's why I said this Baylor defense, the last ranked defense in the country, just cannot line up and stop Oklahoma. They've got to be aggressive, they got to be unpredictable and try to force some errors.
Number 56, 5-yard penalty, it's first down.
And we should talk about number 56 because that is Ty Darlington, who takes over for Gabe Eichard, who did not start because of a concussion problem. And so Darlington, the freshman, got the start, and he is a 6'3", 266-pound player. It'll be first down and 15.
And you're right, we should talk a little bit about him because he's in a tough position. Hasn't played a whole lot, and to come in and be a center, especially with these shotgun snaps, it's tough for a young guy.
Jones, with plenty of time, completes the pass, and dragging his man inside the 38-yard line is Justin Brown, the huge receiver, the transfer from Penn State, for a gain of 12.
And again, the key is there's no pressure whatsoever on the quarterback, Landry Jones. This defense gives up 327 yards a game passing. Can't do that.
Oklahoma runs for what appears to be a first down. It depends on where they mark it. They do mark it for a first down. I wasn't sure if he stepped out at the 35, but Hager and Casey were able to run him out at the 33.
And the tempo, you can see doing a great job of playing fast, not allowing Baylor to really get set up.
Another completion, this time to Jalen Saunders. Well, he's got good hands.
He sure does. It's so quick and fast, in and out of his breaks, works the middle of the field, and that this time he goes outside. 5'9", 160 pounds, kind of ideal size for a guy to work in that slot.
He has only 24. He has 24 catches, excuse me, in only four games, because the first four games he was not allowed to play, transferring from Fresno State.
And now look what, I don't know what Baylor's doing defensively, but you know, it looks like they're playing way inside off of Kenny Stills, and nobody's up there covering.
Play, big hole, left side, inside the 15.
I think just an alignment error by the Baylor defense that time, and Oklahoma runs right at the deficiency. They didn't have enough players on that side of their defense. They get blocked.
Right now, Clay, a big part of their offense, and Josh Heupel told us earlier in the week, he's the co-offensive coordinator, and Josh was saying to be able to run was so important. They only ran for 108 yards and two losses this year to Kansas State and Notre Dame. And dominating on the ground early in this one against Baylor. Hicks and Mason combined for the tackle. It is a first down at the 11-yard line. Bears need some stops. Right now the Sooners have outgained them on the ground by 30. This is only Oklahoma's second drive. The run, it's Damian Williams to the 7. And because his helmet came off, the new rule says he must come out for at least one play. He was a question mark earlier in the week because of an ankle injury he suffered at Iowa State.
Only played a few plays at Iowa State, but that young man's had a big year coming in as a junior college transfer for Oklahoma. Had that huge game against Texas in that Red River rivalry game.
The best running back coming out of the junior college ranks, in All-American at Arizona Western. They'll run the ball again, and this is Clay to the goal line.
See, Oklahoma right now just dominating the interior of the line of scrimmage. Nothing fancy, just running straight ahead that inside zone play. Time Brennan Clay breaks a big one and just short of the end zone, but right now this offensive line of Oklahoma just taking over inside and only the second series.
They run to the right, and it is an easy score for Oklahoma. Brennan Clay, with his fifth rushing touchdown this year, has both Oklahoma scores.
Brennan Clay just bounces this one outside. It looks like it's an inside zone again, but he just bounces it outside, and Baylor's playing everybody inside. Just it's a good block by the wide receiver and an easy walk into the end zone.
Time for a Mazda game break. Let's check in with Kevin Frazier.
Steve, I'm double down. I have a pair of Heisman Trophy winners here, Marcus Allen, and we're honored to have Tim Brown in the house. Let's get right to the football, guys, because number one, Alabama in trouble. Johnny Football in Texas A&M getting it done, Tim.
I've been saying all week this guy's going to be trouble for Alabama. He's proven to be just that.
It's the art of improvisation, making something out of nothing, Kevin. Nobody does it better than Johnny Football.
Johnny Manziel in Texas A&M. A&M up 14-0. Steve.
Thank you, Kevin. And we thought that might take place because Alabama had to have a little bit of a letdown after their emotional win against LSU last week.
Johnny Football, he's creeping up into that Heisman talk. I mean, now there's some people nationally talking about that he's got to be in that race. And if they continue this and they beat Alabama today and he plays well, I mean, I think he throws himself right into that mix.
Oklahoma with a 14-3 lead over Baylor. Art Briles has to play catch up, and he has the offense to do that. They have been averaging 39 points per game this year. Excuse me, 44 points per game. I was looking at the Oklahoma line. Patrick O'Hara with the big leg. They use him going into the teeth of this strong win. Michael Honeycutt is their conversion guy and field goal kicker. could lead number five and number seven Darryl Stoneham back for Baylor. Stoneham. Take it at the 25, young man. He will. The BMW scoring drive for Oklahoma. Once again, 5.5 minutes, 12 plays, 75 yards, perfectly executed, not only by Jones, but as you talked about, that offensive line did great work.
No question about it, for two drives in a row. And the most impressive thing is they've been able to put long drives together, take time off the clock, and then also score, but keep this Baylor offense off of the field. So they're helping their defense as well.
Meantime, the nation's passing leader, Nick Florence, just 2 for 5 and only 8 yards. Seastrunk. He is exciting. First down past the 40-yard line, tackled by linebacker Tom Wart. Gain of 16. He has wiggle ability.
Yeah, he does. And that time, I think OU defensively was just out of sync because there was too much room on the outside for Seastrunk.
Last week I asked Art Briles before the Kansas game if Seastrunk was getting better, or I said, how is he at following his blocks? And he said he's getting better, which told me that's what was keeping him out of the lineup earlier in the season.
And patience. And that's the key word for a running back, especially a speed guy like Seastrunk. A lot of times they just want to get the ball and run fast.
They swing it to Lake. They have him one on one, and he escapes one would be tackler. How about Baylor's keys to victory?
Well, for Baylor, they can't be one dimensional. They can't just come out and try to throw the ball all over the field. They've got to get Seastrunk going like they're trying to do now. And then defensively, like we talked about in the first drive, they got to get off the field. They've been hurting themselves too often, and on third downs, they've been killing themselves, and they can't get off the field. And that's why they've struggled so much this year.
They cannot get penalties against Oklahoma. They know they have to play a near perfect game to beat these Sooners. And a penalty here pushes the football all the way back to the 33-yard line, where it will be second down. And now you'll see a blitz coming from Oklahoma. They're showing a five-man rush. And here it comes. Florence tries to run. No. Loss of 2. Frank Shannon on the tackle.
Frank Shannon, their nickel linebacker, the athletic speed guy. They call him also a shutdown linebacker because he can cover virtually any running back that they're going to play against him. They bring him on blitzes, as we just saw in that sack, or he can drop into coverage as well.
Meantime, Oklahoma's offense has been outstanding on their first two drives, led by Landry Jones. Stills for a first down. Play for the touchdown. The next drive, he went right back to his inside receivers. And the guy who ended it was Brennan Clay. A 1-yard touchdown run. He has both scores for the Sooners, who lead Baylor now by 11.
Talk about balance. That first drive, they go down the field really primarily throwing the ball. Landry Jones 5 of 6 on that first touchdown drive, and then coming back in the second drive, really they ran the ball and established the line of scrimmage. So now you talk about balance offensively. Oklahoma doing a great job.
Third down and 19. Florence tried to dump it off to Salubi, and actually he threw the football a little too hard, as close as the proximity was to Salubi. Yeah, fourth down.
He didn't have much of a chance anyway. Oklahoma was playing deep zone coverage, just forcing the ball to be thrown short so they could rally up to it. And even just the pressure with the four-man line was able to disrupt that entire play.
And Briles and his offensive coordinator, Philip Montgomery, saying that one penalty hurt us because Seastrunk gave them an opportunity on third and short, but the penalty put them way back on second and 17. Here's the punt, line drive, kick. Chance for a return by Justin Brown, and he does not gain much. A 22-yard line. Hey, fans, coming up next, our Fox Sports Network's college football triple header continues as Southern Miss takes on SMU in a Conference USA showdown live from Dallas. That's a good one. I mean, look at the standings in the West. Tulsa unbeaten in league play, 7-2 overall. And then you have SMU and Houston two games back.
Big for SMU trying to get to that magical 6-win number 2 in bowl eligibility. Big game for them.
Does Baylor's defense have a stop in them? They'll run the football. And a huge hole for Oklahoma. They get the first down out near the 33. Bryce Hager taking down Damian Williams.
And you know, running backs have got to make somebody miss. You can't block everybody on defense. Damian Williams does a good job that time of making a guy miss in the hole and then turning that what should have been a short run into a big gain and a first down.
Well, they're dominating in every facet of the game right now, outgaining 146-24 over Baylor. Run it to the left this time, Damian Williams. I like this kid. I mean, I watched him on video, particularly that game he had against Texas when he went for 167 yards, including a 95-yard run.
Yeah, and you talk about making a guy miss. He froze a guy on that 96-yard run, froze the safety, and was able to get outside and then use his speed.
Unfortunately, Rodney Chadwick now leaving the field, injuring his right knee, gone for the season. Fortunate for the senior from Carthage, Texas. That's the final play of the first quarter. It's been all Oklahoma. We knew they had a marvelous offense, an offense that averages just under 40 points per game, has 14 in the first quarter. You are watching Fox College Football. Fox College Football is presented by Frost Brute Coors Light, the game's most refreshing beer, and by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price every day. Norman, Oklahoma, paying tribute to our servicemen and women throughout the world as this is Veterans Day weekend. A beautiful afternoon in Norman, Oklahoma. The Sooners with a 14-3 lead over the Baylor Bears. Second down and 8 for Landry Jones, who has had plenty of time to throw, and he wings it to the left, completes the pass to number 17, Trey Maguire. That's his 16th catch this season. 5-star recruit out of White House, Texas.
And Maguire runs that out route, and Sam Hall is coming from the safety position and trying to cover because they blitzed the corner.
Dominique Whaley with a nice inside run. But just watching Jones throw, JC, the ball comes out of his hand so easily.
Well, I'll tell you what, Steve, we saw these Sooners week one against UTEP, and it wasn't coming out that quickly because of the confidence and the comfort level that we talked about with these wide receivers. But now, like you said, I mean, that comfort level, that trust, and now look at the ball. Comes out, should be caught, obviously.
That's Deron Neal, a backup wide receiver out of St. Louis. He's a true freshman, so we'll give him a break. But you're right. Brown, who came from Penn State, wasn't on the same page. Jalen Saunders, who
wasn't
was
even
not
playing
eligible
then.
The right. First 4 games out of Fresno State. And Sterling Shepard, he is a talented true freshman out of Oklahoma City, whose dad, who passed away, used to play for the Sooners. Play back in the game as the Oklahoma running back on third down, and the Sooners are perfect converting their third downs, 3 for 3 today. Well, that time they brought the blitz, and Jones, I'm not sure his running back ran the wrong way, but Landry very upset.
Yeah, obviously somebody didn't run the right route. He was expecting his running back to run that wheel route, it looked like, and he just stayed flat.
And Bob Stoops has to be thinking, you know, we've got a chance to really take control of this game. Now we're giving it back to a Baylor offense. that averages 44 points per game. We have held them down early, but for how long? The Sooners held their opponent to under 200 yards passing in six different games this year, the most in the Big 12, but they're going up against the best pass offense. Go into the end zone, be taken by Baylor at the 25-yard line after a 50-yard punt. Well, we're in the Big 12 Conference where they love their college football. That means plenty of passion, plenty of emotion as the Sooners take on Baylor in Norman. Oklahoma by 11, Baylor's lone highlight, the third longest field goal in school history, hit by Aaron Jones, who you just saw. Banked this one from 58. Only Bubba Hicks back in 1975 against Rice. He had the longest from 60. Our Coors Light game summary. Aaron Jones with the field goal. You see what Baylor's done, just 24 yards and 9 plays, and Jones. Two of his three incompletions were drops by his receivers.
Yeah, he's very accurate throwing the ball today, especially with this wind being what it is. Surprising that he's throwing the ball so accurately.
The wind in the face of Nick Florence now. And they're trying to get some kind of ground game going as Oklahoma has held them to only 16 total yards on 4 carries. Glasgow Martin, a gain of 5, 3rd and 5. Nelson on the tackle. But this is a Baylor very potent offense, as they see by their national rankings.
Yeah, and those are, like you said, national rankings, not Big 12 rankings. So they lead the country in passing yards a game and in total offense.
And Art wants them to speed up.
Yeah.
He almost looked like Chip Kelly of Oregon.
Yeah, and their tempo offense, I mean, their goal is to run 85 to 100 offensive plays a game. But this is the best defense I think that they've played all year. It's going to be a big challenge for them. The best offense in the Big 12 against the best defense statistically in the Big 12 and OU.
You know, Art Briles is a legend in Texas high school history. He guided Stephenville High School to 4 state titles. And last week before the Kansas game, I asked him, when did you go to this spread? And he goes, 1985. He goes, we were 13-0-1 running the veer, but I knew when we got against the powers, they'd just put 8 in the box and they would be stronger. So we figured we got to spread it out, and they spread it out ever since. And he has had an offensive juggernaut. And look who he has recruited and coached. Robert Griffin III, Heisman Trophy, Case Keenum, the more passing yards than any quarterback in NCAA history. And Kolb and Kingsbury have both played in the NFL.
Yeah, and it helps to be able to run this offense when you have quarterbacks like that. And you can see they want to go fast here. But you got to give the defense time to get on the field and get set. But they want to speed up their tempo, try to create some things offensively.
On 3rd and 5. I wonder if they'll go to Terrence Williams. He looks left, throws underneath, ball is knocked down. It's intended for Lanier Sampson. He has only gone to Terrence Williams once.
Well, they try to get a rub route at the top. Watch up here. You can see that he's just going to come down, and they're going to try to rub off the cornerback there, but they don't do a good job of it. Aaron Colvin, the cornerback, does a great job of recognizing it and hugging up. That's what they call hugging up to the receiver, and then just runs with them and makes the play.
That's what you call a veteran. So here's the first punt. Went for 50 yards and now into the teeth of a strong wind to a very dangerous Justin Brown, who's one of the top return men in the nation, averaging close to 18 yards per return, and a kick that angles to the right
prior
side.
To the snap. The way game, offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
Terrible start for Art Briles' Bears.
And field position is going to be a key because, you know, Oklahoma, punt return, one of the best in the country in terms of average as well as kickoff return. and that creates field position for their offense. You can see fourth in the country right there in punt return average. You can do that. You can set your offense up and to play on the short field.
Line drive kick over the head. How about that? Into the teeth of the wind. Brown picks it up and he will go down at the 27 yard line. Landry Jones, one of the top quarterbacks in America, now over 2,500 yards this year and 17 touchdowns. We'll talk more about him when we come back. Fox College Football is presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price every day. And on your way home, make a late night foodie call at Jack in the Box. Steve Fizziok, J.C. Pearson, Laura McKeeman at Norman, Oklahoma on an absolutely gorgeous afternoon for college football. Temperatures in the low 70s. Sooners lead by 11. Jones with all kinds of time, and he wings it past Jalen Saunders, who got open, moving past the safety Mike Hicks. Time of possession is absolutely key. The Sooners have dominated that 12 and a half minutes almost. Got the ball back. Baylor's mainly been three and out. He goes right back over the middle, and Sterling Shepard, freshman there. Hicks with the tackle, but it's a first down for Oklahoma.
Sterling Shepard and Jalen Saunders, those two guys do a great job of finding the holes in the zones in the middle of the field.
That time a low throw to Kenny Stills, a rare off-target miss by Landry Jones. He's usually been right on the numbers.
And those out routes are going to be open all day, because if you watch these Baylor corners play, and they play a lot of man, they play inside shade. So they're way inside of the receivers. So the outside routes are wide open, and look for them to get a double move to get down the field as well. But look how they're going to try to run the safety over the top of Still.
Busting outside is Damian Williams. He'll get a short gain. Casey and Lackey take him down. Still needs seven for a first down, so Baylor facing another critical third down conversion. Jones has missed on his last 4 of 5. Dead last in the Big 12 in third down conversions. Opponents converting 58% of the time.
Yeah, not just the Big 12, but the entire country, unfortunately, for Baylor.
Three receivers to the right side, one Stills to the left. Nice catch by Matuire, who had to reach back for the football. Excuse me, that was Justin Brown.
They run Justin Brown from the outside on a dig route, just the deep end. Everyone else goes down the field and just clears the middle of the field off. Justin Brown just runs right to the open spot.
Jones, the pride from Artesia, New Mexico, a high school All-American.
And then how about that? Another third down conversion allowed by Baylor.
From the 48. Play action. Jones over the middle. He had to get rid of it a little too early because Baylor brought two linebackers from the inside, and they were right in the face of Landry.
Yeah, but I think Landry had time to really wait and step into that throw. I think he rushed this throw just a bit. Look at the pressure coming right inside in his face. Sees the pressure, and I think he just kind of rushes it just a bit and short arms that throw.
Second down and 10 as defensive coordinator Phil Bennett trying to make the adjustments for Baylor to keep his Bears in this game. Almost intercepted. Eddie Lackey had it in his hands, and he would have gone the distance.
A good read by Lackey. Landry Jones goes through his reads, but Lackey, and those are the plays you've got to make, though. If you want to upset a top 15 team like Oklahoma, you've got to take advantage of all your opportunities. That time, Eddie Lackey had a chance for pick six, but couldn't quite hold on to the ball.
Another opportunity for the Baylor defense. They have forced a third and 10. But can they get pressure on Jones? No, and he unloads right side. It is broken up. Good coverage by Joe Williams.
Baylor finally able to get off the field on third down. A couple of plays, Eddie Lackey knocks down a ball on second down, forces third and long, and then Joe Williams has good coverage down the field, and they get a chance to get off the field.
Art Briles knows he's got to get his offense going somehow. Baylor held to only 3 points in the first half by Oklahoma. Tries to angle it. He does, and it will go into the end zone. When we return, we'll take you to our Fox College football studio for a halftime preview with Kevin Frazier and Tim Brown.
Coming up at the half, we're going to preview the Bear Bryant Bowl, Alabama and Texas A&M. And check this out. We've doubled down on Heisman Trophy winner Tim Brown in the house. Tim, what are you doing with the football and the pump?
I'm just making sure they're inflated for Marcus, you know, USC. I'm just making sure they got enough air. This is going to be good for you, Marcus.
Hey, Kevin, yeah. That was the plan. We found out the kid was from South Bend, Indiana.
clearly, we're going to have a lot of fun in the studio today. Honored to have Tim here. Steve, let's get back out to you and Jason.
How about that?
Yeah, Notre Dame-USC coming up in a couple weeks, huh? Imagine those two men. They're going to really be going at it.
The luck of the Irish has been pretty good so far this year. Lawrence swings at the C-struck. Nice escape down the left sideline. This is what he can do.
That's what they need more of. They need somebody to make a play. C-Strunk with his quickness and his speed is a guy that can do that, but they've also got to get their big two guys involved, Tevin Reese and Terrence Williams. Those are your two main guys. They've been quiet. You got to give them an opportunity to make a play for you.
Florence will run, has a short gain of about 3 yards. Ran very well in the quarterback position last week in their victory over Kansas, but only 3 points against the Oklahoma defense today. C-Strunk off to his left, the high school All-American from Temple, Texas, who transferred from Oregon. They wing it to the right, intended for Terrence Williams. Boy, that was an early hit by DeMontre Hurst, and I thought they might have a flag.
No, DeMontre Hurst doing a great job of being aggressive with Terrence Williams and then making a play on the football. Did a great job, and that's, you know, almost his third interception. I mean, that's 3 pass breakups, but he's been in position to make interceptions on all 3 of those.
3rd and 7. Baylor 0-for-3 on 3rd down.
Now they move Terrence Williams inside in the slot. Might be trying to get him the football.
Going deep. The catch is made. Baylor with a huge play. 1st down inside the Oklahoma 30.
Lanier Sampson just single coverage out there with Julian Wilson. Julian Wilson just misplays the football. Norwood does a good job of coming back and making that play. Julian Wilson just overruns it.
Empty backfield for Baylor. Great opportunity to get back in the game. Florence with a huge hole. A 1st down inside the 10 to the 5.
What a great call by Baylor and a recognition by Nick Florence. And he doesn't run the ball an awfully lot, but he's very capable, as we saw. Oklahoma in man coverage and just boards the middle of the field.
He does the same thing and they score. Let's see the ruling on the play. Yes, touchdown, Baylor.
Touchdown.
Saying he got over, broke the plane of the end zone before the ball came out as he was stretching it out. But obviously they saw something in that Oklahoma defense. The last 2 plays, they were both quarterback draws, one for a long gain and the next one for a touchdown.
That was Mike Stoops, who's furious. He wants them to at least check the replay. He's the defensive coordinator.
The ruling on the field that the quarterback scored a touchdown prior to losing possession is under further review.
Wow, it's going to be close.
Over the plane.
Yeah, it's going to be close. As he starts to stretch out, he loses that football. I don't know if he ever broke the plane with possession.
The whole key, though, it seems like in this day and age, definitive.
It's got to be indisputable. No question about it. And it was ruled a touchdown on the field, so they've got to have enough evidence to show that he never broke the plane of the end zone, or that he did.
JC, that play, though, is that the advantage of this dramatic spread where they were able to get the linebackers away from the middle, allowing Florence up the middle?
It is, especially the way Oklahoma's playing defense is they're playing man-to-man all over the place, and so they're spread with those guys like you're talking about. And now that opens up a lot of running lanes for the quarterback draw. Obviously, they recognized that and ran two quarterback draws and got to the end zone, if this holds up.
Let's take another look at the alleged touchdown.
And it's hard to tell where he was and where the ball was when the ball started to come out.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands.
Must be definitive.
Yeah, and that's the thing. I think because there wasn't a clear shot to show that that ball came out prior to him breaking the plane of the end zone. Now, I think if it would have been called the other way on the field, I think it would have stood that way as well.
Bob Stoops knows that Baylor right back in this game. They were trailing by 11. The Sooners were dominating. But one huge throw from Florence to Norwood gave them a first down at the 30. And then, boom, two quick plays and runs by Florence. And Art Briles' team has cut it to 14-10. Wow. In Waco, they call it a quick strike offense. We saw it on that drive, 80 yards in just six plays.
They can make plays. Throw the ball out to Seastrunk, makes a couple guys miss, and gets down the field, and that started the drive, and then this was the big play in the drive. Levi Norwood makes a great adjustment on the football, and then from there, Nick Florence, on a designed quarterback run, takes it all the way down the field. And then here's the touchdown. And comes right back with another quarterback draw and gets into the end zone. And then, like you said, Steve, this offense is a quick strike offense. Only took them six plays. And look at that, a minute 22.
Florence finally picking it up. He had a slow start. But the pass to Norwood was absolutely huge. And once again, they must hold on to the football because of the 25 to 30 mile an hour breeze is coming from the south. And that is the direction that Jones will kick it. So he'll try and keep it low. Finch and Clay for a chance for the return. They will get it up near the 30 yard line. Time for a Mazda game break. Let's check in with Kevin.
Steve, Alabama finally gets on the board at home in Tuscaloosa against Texas A&M. TJ Yeldon cashes it in. It's 27. Bama's still struggling and in trouble in the second quarter.
Texas A&M, after Alabama had a remarkable come-from-behind victory over LSU, perhaps the emotion not altogether as they were facing the Aggies, a new team to the SEC. Here in the Big 12 Conference, it's Baylor who knocked off Oklahoma by 7. Brilliant drives executed by RG3, who's now playing for the Washington Redskins. So Jones will call timeout, and it comes with 9:34 remaining in the first half. But Jones, coming off a game where he threw for 405 yards and 4 touchdowns last week. It was the 5th time in his career he has done that. Did it in a victory over Iowa State, allowing the Sooners to push the record to 6-2 and 4-1. day's matchups, number 11 Oregon State at number 14 Stanford, number 15 Texas A&M at number 1 Alabama, and A&M leads that one by 13. And later tonight, Kansas State is at TCU. And that game will be on Fox as Colin Klein trying to take another step closer to the Wildcats' first Heisman Trophy.
Yeah, will he play or will he not? I mean, there's still some questions, I believe, as to if Colin Klein is even going to be able to play in that game.
Well, you know, Bill Snyder is very open with all injury reports.
Yeah. And all the media tells you everything you want to know.
Is he one of the great coaches of all time, doing it not only once but twice at Kansas State? They are number 2 in the nation. You can watch him tonight on Fox. Jones handing the football off to Damian Williams. He has a strong run. First down inside the 48-yard line. Dixon and Hager combined to bring him down. But that's a 12-yard run by Damian.
Wow. Good, strong running, breaking tackles, coming back across the field. When you have guys like Damian Williams, Brennan Clay, you can continue to rotate those guys, and they're fresh. And you got those fresh legs in the game all the time. It makes it tough on a defense.
He has the speed to run past you, the power to run over you. Why not run it again? And Williams with a short gain inside the 45. He now has 43 yards on 8 carries, well over 5 yards per carry.
You know, I'm surprised this Oklahoma defense is not going faster. You know, they scored touchdowns the first 2 drives of the game, and they were very up-tempo. They were going fast those first 2 drives. Since then, they've not scored a touchdown, and they've slowed it down. So they might need to go back to that tempo that they played with at the beginning of the game.
Seems like Coach Stoops more determined to go on the ground, and he will again. Short gain, it'll be 3rd down and about 5 or 6 as Casey came up to make a nice play. Number 9, the senior from Crosby, Texas. This is his 22nd start at cornerback. He's also had 6 starts at safety coming into the season for Art Briles. They had to move over from safety to corner because they've had 2 injuries to KJ Morton and also Demetrius Goodson at the cornerback spot, and that has hurt them.
See, it looks like Casey down here playing man to man on Kenny Stills. He backs off and inside. That out route should be wide open.
Jones throwing it to a wide open Sooner, and Sterling Shepard falls down but gets the first down near the 10.
And that's been a problem for Baylor all year. Blown assignments, and you can see Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator on the sideline, really, really upset in the yellow jersey. But Sterling Shepard just runs down the sideline and is wide open. There's Phil Bennett right there, upset, can't believe that there was another blown coverage.
Bob Stoops will bring in the 2 fullbacks, Ripkowski and Millard. He hands the ball off, short gain to the 10 of about 3 yards. Jones today with a passing touchdown to Brennan Clay, and then Clay ran it in from 1 yard out. He'll give it back to Williams. He sweeps the left side to the 5. He's to the 3-yard line and gets another first down after the tackle by Mike Hicks.
How about the tempo that time? Just runs to the line of scrimmage, runs that outside zone. It's good blocking. The left tackle and also the fullback, Ripkowski, lets him get to the edge.
Williams does has 7 rushing touchdowns this year. Will it be 8 on this play? Williams, yes it is. Touchdown.
Got some good blocks up front. Left tackle Lane Johnson, number 69, just blocks down. Then they kick out, and just an easy run for Damian Williams.
That offensive line of Lane Johnson, Adam Shedd, Ty Darlington, Bronson Irwin, Darrell Williams really doing an excellent job opening up huge holes for Damian Williams. He now has over 600 yards rushing this season.
Yeah, but really getting some good blocks up front. Watch him block down, block down. They kick out with the fullback. Great job there. And then just a huge hole. Just jogs into the end zone. Look at Lane Johnson, blocks down, does a great job. And then they kick out with the fullback, Ripkowski. And nobody there for Damian Williams.
Damian now 14 carries for 64 yards and the touchdown. But the big play was Jones throwing it to Jalen Saunders for the first down. Yeah, Sterling Shepard, excuse me.
It was Shepard. I believe Shepard is the number three guy. No, Shepard's number two. Look at him just run that out and up, that wheel route. And the cornerback completely loses sight of him and tracks number one. But he just runs that out and up from the slot, number two. And just a blown coverage by Baylor. And that allowed the big play for Oklahoma. Then they go down and score a touchdown.
With the wind to his back, as you see the BMW Ultimate Drive, Patrick O'Hara with that strong leg, he almost kicks it through the uprights. 25 mile an hour southern wind helping him out. But that's the way you answer Baylor's scoring drive, by taking the football right down the field and not fooling around. They were running the ball well.
Yeah, they sure were. The offensive line again, but then they got back to their tempo. They started getting back on the ball quickly and running plays and not allowing that Baylor defense to get set. And that's when they were able to make their big plays passing and running.
Baylor has 53 yards rushing, Oklahoma 91. Florence had an excellent drive his last time, 80 yards and six plays. Seastrunk, the game breaker, remains his lone setback. Now they'll bring an H back in from the tight end spot. Run Seastrunk. He gains about four. Baylor fans saw his excellence in their spring game when he ran for 138 yards in only seven carries. Blitz on, Florence going deep, man open, incomplete. Man was Terrence Williams.
Oklahoma brings pressure off the edge that time. And they just run a go route right here. Terrence Williams on Aaron Coleman. He's got a step on him. Ball just a little bit overthrown.
Terrence with only two catches for 8 yards. He leads the nation, averaging over 167 yards per game.
Yeah, you got to keep going to him.
Oh, no question. Yeah. He is a fabulous receiver.
He is in the slot right here. And if it's not up the field, run him on crossing routes. The middle of the field is wide open.
Illegal substitution. 12 men in the formation. Defense. 5-yard penalty. It's the third down.
This will make an interesting call for Art Bryos, because it'll be third and short. Do you run Seastrunk against that very strong defensive line of Oklahoma?
They've been running the ball quite a bit today. Now they come in with the bigger running back, Glasgow Martin, who's 220 pounds. So now Oklahoma's got to be conscious of the run.
They'll also have Jordan Niver, the tight end, who will actually be an H-back to the left side. And they run straight up the middle, and Glasgow Martin gets the important first down. Bryos loves to throw, but he knows how important it is to be able to run. Florence must scramble. Completes the pass to Lanier Sampson, his 40th catch this year.
That's a Nick Florence was the guy that made that play. Everything seemed to have broken down. The pressure was there, was able to get away from the pressure, move away in the pocket, but keep his eyes down the field and see Lanier Sampson coming back to him.
somehow they have to get Terrence Williams involved. They do run Glasgow Martin, and he is their hammer back, where he's their slasher and Seastrunk's their guy who can get to the corners.
Yeah, he's the Thunder in the Thunder and Lightning pair. He's the downhill physical guy, 220 pounds, who tries to wear the defender, the defense down inside.
This time, Tom Worth, the middle linebacker, stays right over that center. Almost expecting Martin to get the football. No play action pass going deep. Terrence Williams incomplete. It almost seemed like Nick Florence said, the wind is in my face. I'm really going to get some air under it. And he overthrew his target.
And he's got to get a little bit more air under it and try to give Terrence Williams a chance to run under it. But the play action to begin with holds the safety inside because he's got a read run. That allows Terrence Williams to get one-on-one against the corner.
Third down.
And again, he's your big play guy, Terrence Williams. Don't just run him down the field. Run him on some slants or some stops.
Glasgow Martin hammers his way close to a first down. I think that last surge got it. Good blocking, and they have an All-American candidate in Cyril Richardson, the huge offensive guard. A good block that time.
A good push by the entire offensive line. They just run straight ahead. Straight zone play. And everybody just gets a great push up front.
Blitz from the corner. Florence is sacked. David King will get credit for the sack, but they blitzed the left cornerback, and he was in the face of Nick Florence.
Yeah, it was actually a safety coming off the edge right there, and then there was no blitz adjustment by Terrence Williams. That was Tony Jefferson coming off the edge. Terrence Williams, the receiver, is supposed to blitz adjust and run the slant. He didn't do that. Nick Florence had nowhere to throw the ball.
Second and long. They'll need 16. Florence will run. He gets back to the original line of scrimmage and one more, so it'll be third down and 9. Tackled by Lamar Harris. And you just wonder if Arbrough's saying this is four down territory for us.
Oh, no question about it for them. So you don't have to try to get it all here if you're thinking it's four down territory. Just get some of it. Leave yourself a manageable fourth down distance.
Once again, they have spread the midfield. There's no linebackers right over Florence. Jefferson does creep up from his safety spot. Nick looks downfield, completes the pass. They've got the first down to the 28. It's only Williams' third catch of the afternoon.
That's what they've got to do. They've got to work him in other areas of the field and not just try to get him on go routes down the field. They've got to work him across the middle. He's a big body guy. He can take the licks across there and still make the catch.
Florence to run his man. This time it is Levi Norwood, who is a slot receiver.
I tell you what, Tony Jefferson is an impressive safety. Makes a lot of plays in space. That time again in one-on-one, makes the tackle. 44 solo tackles on the season. This shows you that he's able to come up and play in space and make those tackles like he just did.
Florence to run. This time the inside tackle was able to get to him first, and then Jefferson finished him off.
Again, aggressive safety that's able to run the alleys and make the tackles. A sure tackler, that's what you got to have out of a safety, because if he misses, there's a lot of room behind him. But he's had a great season, leads this Oklahoma team in tackles.
Williams in the slot on the bottom of your screen. He's one of the top receivers in the country. Now he goes motion. They hand the ball off to Williams, who gets the first down to the 15-yard line. It's taking a page out of the Oregon State offense, the way they used to run James Rogers.
Yeah, you see him there. Just normally they don't use him in this situation. He's a bigger, stronger guy. They usually use Tevin Reese, the quick, fast guy, to run that jet sweep, but that time Terrence Williams able to get the first down.
Glasgow Martin hammers his way to the 10. Boy, I like this guy. Glasgow Martin, a junior from Round Rock, Texas, added 10 pounds in the offseason. Had a slow start, but a huge game last week, 157 yards on only 11 carries. To the right, Glasgow gets about two or three. They need to get to the 6-yard line for a first down.
The clock is not a factor at all. A minute 15 seconds left. There's no rush whatsoever needed by this Baylor offense at this point.
Oklahoma brings in an entirely new defensive line. One linebacker stays in. Florence keeps it for the first and goal. He faked it to Seastrunk, and that kind of froze the entire defense.
Yeah, that zone read. And normally Nick Florence is not a guy that runs the ball very much as a quarterback. Now he's doing a much better job, and actually the last few games he's done a better job of it. And it just gives this offense a different dimension because he's very capable.
Seastrunk escapes outside and will score.
Talked about Tony Jefferson being such a good tackler in space. Well, this time Seastrunk froze him. And as I said, if you can get past that safety initially, there's a lot of room behind him. Seastrunk froze Jefferson, and then got into the end zone pretty easily from there.
Baylor has had two very impressive drives, one from 80 and this one from 75. That took 17 plays and almost 6 minutes off the clock.
Yeah, watch this. This is the lightning part of it. Watch him. Stutter step freezes Jefferson right there and then gets to the end zone. Glasgow Martin is the thunder. Here comes the lightning. Stutter step, dead leg, and look at Tony Jefferson. Just reaches nothing but air.
JC, you were a very good defensive back in the NFL. You must have hated those guys who had that wiggle ability.
No question. Those guys are the toughest ones to stop because, as you see, gives you a little stutter, gets you to stop your feet, and then they're gone.
Was there a guy early in the week when you're studying video that you said, oh man, I gotta try and tackle this guy?
Barry Sanders.
There you go.
The best of all and the quickest of all. And froze a lot of people.
Breaks a lot of ankles, but Bob Stoops knows he has talent in the second half. And this is a wonderful football team in the third quarter. Art Briles has to be proud of his senior. This is a guy who waited in the wings of RG3, the greatest quarterback ever to play at Baylor. And he was very patient. He's still on the Unitas watch list and the Davey O'Brien finalist because of his play this year. Smart kick. Here's the return. Oklahoma with room. Uh-oh is right. And they finally take down the Sooner at the 43-yard line. But still 26 seconds left for Landry Jones. There is a flag down. Or the players down, I beg your pardon.
Yeah, Brendan Clay.
Last week it was Williams who was hurt. And Clay now hurt on this play after making a fine return.
Thought he was going to be able to get out of there. Just got caught from the backside and dragged down. And
B.J. Allen was the man who took him down. Or Clay Fuller. We have two number 23s. Clay, it's good to see him healthy as Baylor did lose their starting middle linebacker, Rodney Chadwick, injured on the first series, injuring his knee, gone for the year.
How about the field position? I know there's only 26 seconds left, but now they do have an opportunity to maybe get 3 points out of this just because of the big kickoff return in field position.
With the wind to their back, and Jones fires, completes it perfectly, very close to a first down to Kenny Stills.
22 seconds is a lot of time, especially with the way that Baylor's playing their corners, playing them inside and giving up everything outside. So catch the ball and get out of bounds, you stop the clock.
And I've got to believe that he might go right back to Kenny Stills. I mean, they've got a great comfort level, what, about over 150 completions between that duo.
Don't be surprised to see a double move here, too. At some point, you'll see an out and up.
Jones looking that way, then going to the right. Out there! Touchdown! Justin Brown! We were talking about Baylor's quick strike offense.
Yeah.
How about the Sooners? Joe Williams is the injured bear.
But how about all set up because of the kickoff return by Brennan Clay,
yep,
and the great field position that they got from there. We talked about that earlier. They're fourth in the nation in punt return average and fifth in the nation in kickoff return average, which equates to great field position. That is what led to this touchdown.
Two plays in 11 seconds covering 45 yards, and Joe Williams injured. They already have a injury depleted secondary, having lost Demetrius Goodson and KJ Morton earlier this year. So Art Briles, he's got to do some soul searching, heading to the locker room after his team had crawled back and made it a game, and now Oklahoma quickly strikes. They now lead by 11, 28-17. And the toss from Jones to Brown.
Yeah, just a go route outside to Justin Brown. And watch him make the adjustment on the ball. The ball is thrown short and inside. And look at Justin Brown. Does a great job of adjusting and coming back inside to make a play on the ball. Nothing fancy, just Justin Brown up there at the top of the screen. He's just going to run a go route. Nothing fancy at all, just down the field working against Joe Williams, and then makes an adjustment on the football there at the end for the touchdown.
Justin with four catches for 70 yards and a score. Landry Jones already having a heck of a football game himself, as he's thrown for 212 yards in the first half alone, 17 for 25. And we told you, once he got comfortable with Brown and Saunders and Shepard, those newcomers, this Oklahoma offense really picked up. Going down to one knee is Baylor. He'll have the football with 15 seconds left. The Baylor running game on their last drive. Nick Florence, the senior, helped out.
And how about Terrence Williams also on the jet sweep, converting the first down, and then the thunder, Glasgow Martin, and then here's the lightning. Or no, here's Nick Lawrence. And now here's the lightning with the quick stutter step there, and that's Lake Seastrunk that finishes off the drive with the touchdown.
With 15 seconds left, they will run inside, and that might be the final play of the first half as Glasgow Martin with a very short game. Yes, they will let it out. Briles heading to the locker room. His team had a chance to only be down by four, but a short kick, a great return by Brennan Clay, and then two tosses for 45 yards and a touchdown. And Art not happy. Actually, he was talking to his teammates, telling him, come on, let's get in the locker room and talk about this.
Yeah. Make some adjustments and come out in the third quarter. I mean, they did some good things. Obviously, they've got to clean up some things defensively, not give up the big play, but offensively, some positive things that they did in that first half.
Well, a win for Bob Stoops would move him past Bud Wilkinson for second most wins in Sooner history with 146. He's 30 minutes away from that. Let's go to Laura.
Coach, Brennan Clay sets you up with great field position there, and you're able to strike, putting more distance on the scoreboard there. Walk us through the final seconds of the first.
Well, it's exactly what we said. If we get it out past the 35, let's go for it. If we're backed up or pinned back, let's not be silly about it and risk something. So it got a big return and we got a big play.
You play a lot of man defense and that can leave you susceptible to big plays downfield. Do you think it's been working well against Baylor? What adjustments will you make in the second?
Well, they've only got one big play, one pass. The run game is what's hurt us. So what I have, 78 yards passing. So I think that part's been pretty good. We got to do a little better job against the run.
All right. Thanks, Coach. Halftime in Norman with the score 28-17, Oklahoma over Baylor. Now we take you to our Los Angeles studio for Fox College Football Halftime with Kevin Frazier, Marcus Allen, and Tim Brown.
Landry Jones and Oklahoma with a 28-17 lead over the Baylor Bears. Steve Fisiak along with J.C. Pearson. And at the beginning of the game, we said Landry Jones was getting more and more comfortable with his receivers. He sure is the way he was spreading it all over the field.
No question about it. Threw the ball to seven different guys in that first half and really did a great job. Threw for over 200 yards. Here he starts out early, throwing the ball to Kenny Stills over the middle and just really spread it around. Touchdown on this first drive to Brennan Clay. Then comes right back. There's Jalen Saunders working the middle of the field, and they really spread the ball around and the different guys. Sterling Shepard on the wheel route comes up with the big play, and then right at the end of the first half, the 35-yard touchdown pass to Justin Brown. Landry Jones had a tremendous first half.
As we take a look at our peak halftime stats, you'll see the number of first downs. Oklahoma with 20 in the first half. They ran for 91. Jones threw for 212. And they dominated the time of possession, 18 minutes to 11:47. And Landry Jones, 17 of 25 in the first half, but he had three drops by his receivers right on target. And, you know, when you talk about baseball, there are pitchers, when they throw the ball, they throw it nice and easy and the ball comes out fast, 95 miles an hour. He throws it nice and easy and the ball has just a beautiful spin to it. Must be and catchable for his receivers.
Yeah, and that's the key word right there, is a catchable ball. Throws the ball with great touch and can throw the deep ball, as we saw for the touchdown, throw the intermediate pass, but then also on the shorter passes, able to take a little bit off of it so that his receivers and running backs can make the play. But Landry Jones threw the ball very well that first half.
When we talked with Josh Heupel, his offensive coordinator, earlier this week, and we asked him how Landry has improved this year, and he said, when you play quarterback, a lot of it has to do with trust. Trust your read, trust your wide receiver running routes. And he is doing that in the latter stages of this 2012 season.
He sure is. Early on, he was holding the ball, waiting for his receivers to come open. Now he's anticipating and throwing it before they're open.
Let's go to Laura.
Steve, I spoke with Baylor head coach Art Briles as they came out of the locker room, and he said his message to his team at the half was that they need to make more of those big plays that they're capable of. He says, just score one more touchdown and it's a four-point game. He also gave a lot of credit to Oklahoma, saying they're playing awfully well right now.
Particularly that drive right before halftime when a kickoff, a short kick, was returned by Brennan Clay inside the 50-yard line, and Bob Stoops decided, let's go for it. Two plays later, they scored seven, and they are up 28-17. Nick Florence at the controls now. Seastrunk. He is taken down after a short gain. Gabe Lynn, the outside linebacker, along with Javon Harris on the tackle. Florence 6 for 14 in the first half for 78 yards. He'll be throwing into the teeth of the wind in the third quarter and then have it to his back in the final 15-minute period. Teams have scored a total of only 16 points against the Sooners in the third quarter this season. He has time, going deep. Terrence Williams, first down inside the 30-yard line.
What a great throw.
right over the top of the safety, Tony Jefferson, number one. And Terrence Williams just catches it right in stride. We've been saying that you got to go to him. He's your main guy, your big play guy. You got to give him some chances.
They say he went out of bounds at the 17, a 56-yard gain, and Seastrunk inside the 10-yard line. So Baylor comes out on fire. Art Briles saying, let's keep things fast. And they are to the line of scrimmage quickly. They bring in Glasgow Martin, who is their hammer back. He's the Thunder. And Thunder gets it and is very close to a first down. Needed to get to the 7. I believe he got it to the 6.
Give this offensive line a lot of credit, too, because they did it at the end of the first half, their last drive, able to just drive the ball down the field, running it. They're doing a good job now, too, also being able to pound the ball. And that sets up the play action.
Martin stays in the game. He has 6 touchdowns, this time taken down on a fine defensive play by safety Javon Harris.
That's not a play that Martin usually runs. He's not a guy that they want to get to the edge and use his speed. They want him to come downhill. You see Javon Harris was able to just run him down outside.
Florence throwing, incomplete. That time the coverage came from Gabe Lynn, who sometimes the lineup as a linebacker, other times as a nickelback.
Just covering a wide receiver, Norwood there. Lynn just not a lot of room to throw the ball there just because they're on the 5-yard line, so he didn't have to cover them very long.
Third and goal. Florence to run. He gets taken down at the 4-yard line. What a great tackle by Tony Jefferson and Tom Wart.
Again, the safety, Tony Jefferson, showing up against the run and making a play in space. See, 49 solo tackles out of his 68. So that's telling you that he's playing in a lot of open space and is able to make those tackles, those one-on-one tackles. That was another big one for this Sooner defense.
So Aaron Jones on, who blasted one from 58 earlier. This will be from 21. It is on the way and perfect. But they hold Baylor to only 3. Terrence Williams with the big play. He now has 4 catches in the game, and this one for 56 yards. 28-20. Oklahoma still leads. When this game started, Oklahoma's defense knew they had to slow down one man. Number 2, Terrence Williams, a game breaker.
He's a big time guy. They do a great job of getting him on the safety. Watch the play action, the run fake, holds the corner outside, and that gets Terrence Williams up on the safety one-on-one. So there's the run fake. The corner's got to honor it, and now Terrence Williams is there. Look at the safety, Tony Jefferson. His hips are inside, so he jumps to the outside. By the time he's able to flip his hips and get back, Terrence Williams is by him, and that's his 4th catch for 75 yards.
Now 75 catches this year, and Jones answered with the 21-yard field goal. They were hoping for 6. They got 3 for 7 with the extra point, but now Jones to kick off. And it will be 24, Brendan Clay, who had that great return just before the break, along with 22, Roy Finch. Into the teeth of a strong wind, so taken at the 25, and Finch escapes outside, still on his feet. 2 huge returns by the Oklahoma special teams today.
5th in the country in kickoff returns. And it creates field position. Now their offense is on the short field. But this pooch kick allows Roy Finch just to jump back up, make a couple guys miss, and now he uses his speed to get all the way back across the field.
36 yards in the return, so another very short field for Landry Jones, and that's always dangerous. He will have Damian Williams as his tailback, and they'll keep Trey Millard in the game, the fullback. Williams sweeps the right side. The ball is out, and Oklahoma has given it up to Baylor, but we'll see what the officials rule. They are giving it to Baylor, and it's Terrence Lloyd coming away with it.
Yeah, no whistle. I didn't hear a whistle up here at all.
Looked like Eddie Lackey was able to get a hand in there.
Damian Williams right here. See Eddie Lackey right there, just his shoulder. That ball definitely comes out before Damian Williams is on the ground. He gets knocked into Eddie Lackey.
The play was stopped. Oklahoma calling a timeout. Bob Stoops may want them to look at it.
First charge timeout, Oklahoma.
Art Briles was very frantic about the play call on the field and wanted to get Nick Florence's attention. Now he does. But it was Oklahoma that called the timeout because the Sooners defense was not set properly. Timeout on the field. The Baylor Bears coming up with their first turnover of the game. Baylor football, Oklahoma with an 8-point lead in the third quarter. Tomorrow afternoon, a special early season college basketball event tips off live from the flight deck of the USS Midway in San Diego. Join Steve Kerr, Dick Enberg, and Aaron Andrews as Syracuse and San Diego State collide in a highly anticipated event. The Battle on the Midway, live from San Diego tomorrow at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific on Fox Sports Networks. This game was originally scheduled for Friday, but was moved to Sunday due to the weather. Baylor with the football. Guess who's breaking free? That is Seastrunk, and he has a healthy game. First down, then goes down, but I believe his knee was already down. It will still be Bears football, a gain of 16.
That's what a guy like Seastrunk gives you, just big play capabilities at any time. See, definitely down before that ball comes out, but just give him a crease. He can break a tackle at any point in time.
Florence to Williams. He overthrew him. That's the second time, same area, he has overthrown Terrence, and T. Will was not happy.
No. See the frustration there. See what Baylor's done since the first quarter. They figured out some things offensively about this Oklahoma defense, and they've had a lot of success.
Seastrunk, not much here. It'll be third down and long. We have seen that Oklahoma defense blitz in these third and long situations, both from their inside linebackers and also from their safeties. Julian Wilson comes in the game.
Well, if I'm Oklahoma, I'm playing zone here. Third and nine. Keep everything in front of you. See the ball and then make the tackle. The problem they've been having playing man to man is everybody's head is turned playing man, and they have allowed the quarterback to run out of there.
Now the safeties creep up. Florence wings it to the right. Great catch by Williams, but excellent coverage by Hurst. Well, it's fourth down.
And Baylor's aggressive offensively. They come out aggressive and they stay aggressive. You see the good hands there by Terrence Williams. But again,
it is knocked down, and it is a turnover into the hands of the Oklahoma Sooners.
Yeah, it looked like it just came out of Nick Florence's hand.
I thought it was tipped, but I guess not.
Yeah, they go in a hurry, and the ball just slips out of his hands. Doesn't get there. I mean, the receiver, Lanier Sampson, is wide open out there. Would have been an easy catch for a first down, but ball just slipped out of Florence's hands.
So they do not take advantage off the mistake by Oklahoma after the fumble by Williams. Miller stays on his feet for about a 3-4 yard gain as Bryce Hager will be credited with the tackle. how important are turnovers? Well, I saw a number earlier today about Kansas State, who's the number two team in the nation. They have outscored their opponents 111-0 on points off turnovers.
Bill Snyder coach team. Yep. They take the ball away. They do give it away. Their defense comes on and makes a play. Watch here, just a boot pass. Oh, no, this is just a false start. The whole left side of the offensive line.
By the way, fans, that Kansas State-TCU game will be on Fox tonight. Heisman Trophy candidate Colin Klein against TCU. The Wildcats, one of six teams still left unbeaten, five eligible for bowls. Ohio State is not. Here's Landry Jones firing, and it's intercepted. Mike Hicks brings it back, so that is back-to-back possessions where Oklahoma has turned it over.
And that is Landry Jones. That's on him, and that's the worst ball that he's thrown today. That's a long throw across the field, and he throws it into coverage. Watch him here trying to go through his progressions, but this is a long throw. Allows Mike Hicks, you can see there's two guys under Kenny Stills and one over the top. Mike Hicks just comes up with the play, tips the ball up, and good concentration to stick with it. But that's not a ball that Landry Jones wants to throw very often.
It is his seventh interception this year. They run Martin. Gain of three, second and seven. Art Briles knows he has to take advantage of opportunities. They did not with the fumble. They must with the interception. Lawrence gives it off to Martin. He is still 2 yards shy of a first down. Frank Shannon made the tackle.
But positive yards, third and short. Very manageable for them, the way that they're running the football with Martin and also with Nick Lawrence. As you can see how turnovers really impact Baylor in terms of their wins and losses.
Plus eight in their four wins, minus 11 in their four losses. They were plus two in ending a four-game losing streak last week against Kansas. First down, Martin. I like the way he follows his blockers and is fast to the hole.
Just coming downhill with power. That's what he does. Just that inside zone, find the crease. He's able to just kind of slip backside just a little bit, find the hole, and get down the field.
He's like the name of his hometown, a Round Rock. He's hammering it inside. They run C. Strunk. Well, he escapes two would-be tacklers because of that great quickness. Incredible feat. C. Strunk had his best moments in the second half against the Jayhawks last week when he ran for 103 yards, a career high. Also had five catches for 91 yards. And he will get to the five. He's to the three. He's to the two-yard line. First and goal, Baylor.
And how about the quickness of C. Strunk to get all the way backside on that inside zone read? Cuts his backside and then up the field. Gets all the way to the two-yard line.
They'll keep C. Strunk in the game instead of Martin. Give it to Lake. He hammers the middle, then pushed back. And did he get in? Yes, he did. Do you go for one or two?
As aggressive as Baylor is, they'll go for two and tie it up. But how about the second and third effort by Lake Seastrock? This offensive line of Baylor, they figured something out about this Oklahoma defense, especially up front, because they are taking advantage at the line of scrimmage and controlling.
So Luby comes in as the setback. Three receivers to the right side, one alone to the left. Now they'll send Norwood in motion. They'll run it. Salubi is stopped. Jefferson, the All-American candidate at safety, made the two-point saving play. So the interception by Mike Hicks does lead to a Baylor touchdown, and the Bears within two of the Oklahoma Sooners. Fox College Football is presented by Frost Brewed Coors Light, the game's most refreshing beer. By Mazda, we believe if it's not worth driving, it's not worth building. And by Whataburger, proud to serve it hot and fresh 24 hours a day. Beautiful afternoon in Norman, Oklahoma. When we started, temperature was 73. Winds out of the south, 25, 26 miles an hour. And our jack-in-the-box Baylor scoring drive, Seastrunk, two-yard run. The play, they went six plays and 28 yards because of the key interception by Mike Hicks, number 17, the 5'11 senior, China Spring, Texas. It's his second year starting. Aaron Jones will now kick off into the teeth of that strong wind.
Yeah, let's see if they pooch kick it again. It hasn't worked for them the last two times.
Well, he hammers it. How about that?
Yeah.
That's a great kick.
Smart.
Our Brown hand center, great hands of the game. How about Mr. Hicks?
Easy one right here. Just led to the touchdown, but great job just tipping the ball up, concentrating on it, and making the play himself. Baylor defense said that they had to create some turnovers. Had to take the ball away. They've done that a couple of times. The offense finally able to convert, get the touchdown off of it.
Hicks with a fine game, 8 tackles, 1 interception. It is a 2-point game. This is Williams. Let's go to Laura.
Steve, you mentioned Mike Hicks' interception. Of course, it brought new life to this Baylor sideline, and the guy most excited, Phil Bennett, the defensive coordinator, who has been trying so hard to motivate this defense that struggled this season.
And Laura, last year Mike Hicks had a huge play, an interception to clinch their victory over TCU. Jones goes underneath to Williams, makes a nice move, but does not get the first down. It will be third down and 2. Last week, J.C., Phil Bennett made great adjustments against Kansas, and they shut out KU in the second half.
Well, they made some great adjustments here today in the second half, not allowing any big plays so far in the second half. Made some adjustments offensively as well. Doing a great job of controlling the line of scrimmage.
They're showing a run look. Blake Bell is come in. He is their rush quarterback. He's rushed 41 times this year for 88 yards and 9 touchdowns. And the flag goes down. And how about that?
Snap infraction. The center. 5-yard penalty. Third down.
The freshman, we talked about it, Ty Darlington. Watch the center. Oh yeah, you're gonna move it. You might as well snap it. You're not gonna get away with moving it halfway. But again, a freshman replacing Gabe Eichard at center.
So Landry Jones comes back in, and now it is a 3rd down and 7. Baylor's defense feeling confident. They'll blitz. Jones throws, completes it. Saunders, first down. They needed 7. They got 12.
And now they're going to their tempo offense, but you can get Saunders lined up on the linebacker, Bryce Hager. They'll take that all day long.
They swing it out to the right side. Nothing but white jerseys over there, and Hager takes down Saunders after he makes his 5th catch of the day.
But Baylor just playing zone defense, dropping back, trying not to let anything be thrown over the top, and they'll react up to anything thrown short. That time they just come up and make the tackle, although it's a 5-6 yard game.
The Quick strike to midfield for another first down as Sam Hull is there to wrap up Justin Brown. Sooners quickly moving down the field, starting from their own 25-yard line. Oklahoma owns a perfect 10-0 record in home games against Baylor under Bob Stoops. And they lead the overall series 20 victories to one. We told you that one loss came last year against RG3 at Waco. Landry with plenty of time. Now he goes deep. Incomplete, intended for Sterling Shepard.
Got time to throw the ball. In the first half, I talked about Baylor defensively having to be a little unpredictable, and that's what they're doing right now. They're giving Landry Jones a lot of unconventional looks and kind of confusing him a little bit, forcing him to hold the ball some. They're blitzing corners off the edge, forcing the safeties to play man on the receivers, and they're just doing things that are a little unpredictable, a little different, and kind of confusing this OU offense just a bit.
They showed blitz from the corner, then they don't come, and they hand the football off to Williams, who has a short gain. It was Williams' fumble on the first drive, which halted a good Oklahoma drive. Then the interception by Hicks led to a touchdown that drew Baylor within two at 28-26. Inside a 4.5 play in the third. Oklahoma is a great 6-for-8 converting third downs. This is 3rd and 8. First down, Oklahoma. And Williams gets it inside the 20, inside the 30-yard line.
Great route by Damian Williams. He's a running back. You don't expect him to be able to run good routes and catch the ball, but he just shook Eddie Lackey, number 5, who was playing coverage on him. Faked him to the inside and went to the out. It's an easy throw for Landry Jones.
They mark him out at the 32. So the Sooners coming right back after a Baylor touchdown. Play action, plenty of time for Jones. Millard gets about 8 back. Looked like Terrence Lloyd went down hard.
Well, Millard is about 256 pounds. Listen to this.
Yeah, check that. That was Brody Trawhon, junior from Dixon, Texas, and he comes out of the game now.
Yeah. As a defender, you want to try to deliver the blow, but that time Trahan got the blow delivered to him by Miller.
This is a little like last week with Oklahoma against Iowa State, where the Cyclones got very little pressure on Jones and he picked them apart, throwing for 405 yards. Second and short. They'll throw and they'll go deep, and it is an incomplete pass intended for Kenny Stills in the back of the end zone. Excellent coverage from Joe Williams.
Yeah, the ball just hung in the air just a little too long. That ball is thrown out to the back of the end zone. It's an easy touchdown. See, Stills has got to wait on the ball, try to make a play on it. Look at Joe Williams. Great job playing the ball in the air and gets his hands up and knocks that ball away. And Joe Williams, only 5'9". So you can expect that a lot of people throw fades on him.
Blake Bell, and the second time Blake has tried a running play, we have had a either false start.
Offside. Defense, number 31. Came into the neutral zone, causing an offensive lineman to false start. It's a 5-yard penalty and yields the first down.
Phil Bennett disagrees, yeah, but they said McAllister was in the neutral zone.
Everybody just trying to get a jump, and he's listening. Oh, McAllister was up at the top there. That was Lloyd at the bottom, number 11. I saw the 1, didn't see the 3.
They get the first down, so Jones comes back in. And Landry keeps it in the ground. Nothing. Ahmad Dixon, the outside backer, is the first to read it. He got help from Nick Johnson, the defensive tackle. Gain of 1.
Number
Third quarter winding down here. Oklahoma with a 2-point lead. They have the wind to their back only this period. Jones has been excellent on this drive.
That's for the fade down below.
Big hole. First down and touchdown. Damian Williams.
Talked about Damian Williams being able to freeze guys in the hole and make guys miss. He made a couple of guys miss there. Throws the safety and just planted that foot and got up the field in a hurry.
Great blocking by that offensive line. Lane Johnson, Adam Shedd, Darlington, Irwin Williams. Let's take a look at that touchdown going to commercial break as Art Briles saying, what do we have to do to slow down this Oklahoma offense? Williams was not even touched. Maybe right at the end, but only a left hand. Damian Williams enjoying his touchdown run of 17 yards, putting Oklahoma up 35-26.
But boy, he got some great blocks. Watch his fullback here, Ripkowski. Watch him seal the edge right here on Terrence Lloyd. Great job, and that allows Damian Williams to get backside. Watch him freeze the safety right there. Plant that left foot, freezes a safety, and then gets straight up the field for the touchdown.
Let's go to Laura.
Steve, you and JC talking about this Oklahoma O-line and giving them the credit. Bob Stoops agrees. He went by, congratulated them, and told them they're a large part of Oklahoma's success offensively today.
Because the Baylor defense has not even approached putting Landry Jones on his backside.
Yeah, no pressure at all. And you know, that's been a problem for him all year. Only 10 sacks all year for Baylor. But today, again, this offensive line has done a great job of protecting Landry Jones, but also creating running lanes for guys like Damian Williams and Brennan Clay.
Patrick O'Hara with the wind to his back. He's been hammering it almost to the end line. And this is a good one again. And it will be Baylor football at their own 25-yard line. Here's a look at the Chase BCS standings. Alabama tested by LSU last week. They're trying to go to 10-0 by knocking off Texas A&M, who at one time had a 20-point lead. Kansas State on Fox. They'll face TCU in Dallas. And then Oregon is at California. Right now there are five teams still unbeaten, including Louisville. And the only once in the last decade has an unbeaten team from a major conference not played for the national title. That was 2004 when Auburn. Louisville lost, though, so make it four as Glasgow Martin goes for about three.
Again, we've been giving that Oklahoma offensive line a lot of credit, but this Baylor offensive line from the last couple of drives of the first half to now really started to play much better, and this offense has started to roll. So this Oklahoma defense has got their hands full.
Louisville lost at Syracuse today. Florence throws to his tight end, and not much running room for Jordan Iver. This will make it third down, and tough decision here. Terrence Williams with five catches for 81 yards. He's down at the bottom.
He's in the slot.
The wide man is Antoine Goodley as they place Williams in the slot. We get a little pick action here. The throw goes to Terrence Williams. Great coverage by DeMontre Hurst, the senior from Lancaster, Texas.
Yeah, he's really challenged Terrence Williams all day long. And that time, he wins. Great job in coverage. Terrence Williams just couldn't get away.
You know what's bad about this? They did not get one first down. If they get one first down, then they enter the fourth quarter, and even if they only have three plays after that, they get the wind to their back for the punt. Instead, they will must kick into the teeth of that wind, and Oklahoma very likely to get great field position, and they also have one of the top return men in the game in Justin Brown, standing at his 30.
Delay game, offense, 5-yard penalty, it's fourth down.
Jalen Saunders, I beg your pardon, is now back deep instead of Justin Brown. I hope that Justin Brown is healthy, because he's one of the great return men in the game. Saunders standing at his 35 now. And they will let it go, and it is down at the 35 and a half yard line. We told you that Bob Stoops needed just one more win to move past Bud Wilkinson for second most wins in Sooner history with 146, 11 shy of Barry Switzer. But if you are mentioned in the same sentence as Bud Wilkinson, most coaches consider that an honor.
I think they've already got a statue ready to go up with Bob, but Bob doesn't want it up yet. He said, wait till I'm done.
Well, he has taken his Sooners team to 13 straight bowl games. And they'll get there again this year as they're heading towards their seventh victory. Clock winding down, 30 seconds remaining in the third quarter. They've had four national championship game appearances, won one, eight BCS bids. Oklahoma, of course, one of the great programs in college football history with 827 wins. That's sixth all time. And you see the number of national championships they've enjoyed, seven. We have played three here in Norman, Oklahoma. The Sooner fans believe as their Sooners attempting to go 7-2 on the season and stay in the chase of Kansas State in the Big 12 Conference. You're watching Fox College Football. Here is today's Coors Light game summary as Baylor trails by 9. Seastrunk 70 yards on 11 rushes. Williams 20 carries for 92 yards. Back and healthy, he has two scores, as he was a question mark before the game because of the injured ankle.
How about Baylor, the number one passing team in the country, with more runs than passes today?
Well, that is what the Oklahoma defense has given them. And Oklahoma, the top pass defense in the Big 12 Conference, as they have allowed just 170 yards per game. Landry Jones has thrown for 270 yards and two scores. He has also been intercepted one time, and that led to a touchdown. So Blake Bell comes on again. This big man at 6'6", 254 from Wichita, Kansas. Bell to run, gets the first down and more. Bell could be gone. Look at this, touchdown Oklahoma.
How about the speed of the big man? 55 yard touchdown, but the patience also. We talked about how running backs have to have patience. Blake Bell, good job just having patience, allowing the block to be set up backside. Everyone thinks it's going to the front side. Comes to the backside and then outruns that entire Baylor defense.
Last year, Blake Bell ran for four touchdowns in their loss to the Bears, as Adam Shedd is still down on the field and injured.
But again, watch the patience here to set up the backside blocking. A great job again by Ripkowski to seal the edge. And look at the big guy motoring down the field. 55-yard touchdown for Blake Bell.
And he is all about football, comes from a great football family. His dad, Mark, played 5 years for the Seahawks and the Colts. His uncle Mike played for the Kansas City Chiefs as a defensive end. And Blake Bell ripping it.
Yeah, it was teammates with Mike Bell.
Well, he is likely the heir to Landry Jones. Point after is good, and Oklahoma beginning to pull away. They now have a 16-point lead over the Baylor Bears. 55 yards on the dash by the kid from Bishop Carroll High School in Wichita. They're taking pictures here in Norman, Oklahoma, of one of their favorite stars, Blake Bell. Call him the Belldozer. In this situation, he didn't need much because his blockers were doing so much work for him.
Yeah, I want you to watch two guys. I want you to watch Bronson Irwin and then Ripkowski, the fullback. Watch Irwin come and kick out, and then Ripkowski blocks down to seal the edge right there. Great job. And now all Blake Bell's got to do is just run. Nobody's there in the middle of the field. All he's got to do is outrun everybody else, and he's got a 55-yard touchdown, but some great blocks up front by Irwin and Ripkowski to get him there.
The last two touchdowns rushing by Oklahoma were supported by Ripkowski. And is that a perfect name for a football player?
And
Butkus.
Yeah.
Nitschke.
For a fullback.
Ripkowski.
And playing with the cast on his left arm.
Fumble picked up. Baylor opens to the right, and Stoneham with a good game. Laura.
Steve, after Blake Bell's touchdown, he was rumbling over to the sideline. He's a big boy, if you haven't noticed, and he bumped right into Coach Stoops. Coach Stoops trying to congratulate him. Blake Bell gave him a little hardcore stuff he's got going on there. Now, Adam Shedd, the offensive lineman for Oklahoma that came off with an injury. It's a right ankle. They taped it up, tried to get it a little more stabilized. Landry Jones came over to Shedd and said, hey, man, we need you. You need to come in the game. We don't have anybody else.
Well, how about that? What about your depth? But Adam Shedd, he has been a big reason Baylor has been unable to get to quarterback Landry Jones. We have a timeout on the field. 14:07 remaining in this football game. The Sooners have opened up a 16-point lead on Baylor. Fox College Football is presented by Academy Sports and Outdoors. Right stuff, low price, every day. And by GEICO. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance. Visit us at geico.com. On an absolutely beautiful evening in the Midwest, we come to you from Norman, Oklahoma. Sooners with the lead over Baylor. Kansas lost in two overtimes to Texas Tech. Texas knocked off Iowa State. West Virginia down 7 to Oklahoma State in the fourth quarter. And later on Fox, it will be Kansas State at TCU. Colin Klein trying to add to his 50 career rushing touchdowns. Blake Bell just ripped for 55 yards. And this Oklahoma defense has really held down the number one passing offense in college football. Florence will run a big hole. He'll get the first down and more to midfield.
Yeah, and that's been wide open all day, because when OU plays man, they're trying to keep their safeties over the top and playing more like two man. And when you do that, there's nobody there to account for the quarterback run.
Salubi off the right side with a healthy gain, but Baylor having much more success running the ball than throwing it against Oklahoma. Baylor has gone over 300 yards passing in all 8 of their previous games thus far this year. They only have 142 yards passing from Nick Florence tonight. Close to a first down, but not enough. They'll mark it about a yard shy, making it 3rd and 1 for Seastrunk. Baylor 7 for 13 on third down. Good gain for the Bears. And that's their hammer back, Glasgow Martin.
He's been a load all night long for Baylor. Well, they need to keep pounding him. Still plenty of time left in this game. 12:48 left to go, so they don't have to just air it out down after down. They can still pound the ball because they're gaining positive yards on the run.
But they must get touchdowns instead of field goals. And here's Florence looking deep downfield. He goes. Tevin Reese dropped the football. That was the first time he has been targeted tonight. He came in with 37 catches, JC.
Yeah, and he's a big time receiver for him, a big play guy. You can't throw this ball any better. I mean, he just drifts away from the football instead of coming to it. I mean, the ball was right where it needed to be. But Tevin Reese, for some reason, and I don't know if it was a wind issue, because now they're throwing into the wind. Maybe at the last second, the wind took the ball, but very uncharacteristic of Tevin Reese.
Seastrunk, he cuts back and gains about three, and then there's a flag down, and it looks like it might be a hold. R.J. Washington on the tackle.
Holding, offense, number 71. 10-yard penalty, repeat, second down.
Cameron Caulfield, senior from Friendswood, Texas.
Those are the ones. Caulfield, 71, the right guard. Just an easy call right there. Just bear hugs Jamarcus McFarland. Doesn't let him go.
And you're really making strides. You get all the way down inside the 40-yard line. Then a pass that should be caught in the end zone. Now a mistake. And Florence will run, and he gets it to the 40, but not much more than that, where it will be third down. And they'll still need about 17 yards for a first down. Coming out, Stacy McGee, because he lost his helmet. He must come out for at least one play. They do have their wind to their back. And they've got a kicker who's blasted one from 58 already. Florence is sacked. The third time Nick has been sacked by Oklahoma's defense.
Yeah, just a four-man rush, and in long yardage situations, it takes a long time before your receivers to get down the field. So with the four-man rush, Florence has got to hold the ball. There's seven guys dropping in coverage, so there's not a lot of room, and that allows the pressure to get to him and the sack.
On fourth down, they are going for it. The field goal would come from 60. Florence looking deep, throws downfield, incomplete. They only rushed four, but they got great pressure from the inside, led by Casey Walker.
Yeah, on fourth and long, especially that long, extremely tough.
Time running out for Baylor. Sooners beginning to play that victory march. Oklahoma leading Baylor 42-26. Here's our Coors Light freeze can. Terrence Williams. Michael Hicks with the big interception that led to a Baylor touchdown. But back came Oklahoma, led by Damian Williams. Jones is thrown for almost 300 yards, and the Belldozer with a 55-yard touchdown run. So back to live action. Oklahoma with the football and with the lead, as Lackey is able to take down the running back, Damian Williams, who is nearing the 700-yard mark rushing this season. He has 96 today, came in with 588.
Come on.
Jones looks to throw. Fakes left, comes back right, and gets a good chunk of yardage, about 7 yards to Justin Brown, his wide receiver. Last year at Penn State, Justin Brown caught 35 passes for 517 yards in an offense that's more geared towards the run, transferred because of the situation at Penn State. Now Blake Bell back in the game. We saw what he did last time he ran the football. Third and short. Blake trying to put this game in the deep freeze. He sweeps to the right side. And let's see where the mark is. I believe it's awfully close to a first down.
They're going to bounce by.
They're going to give it to him. This time he stays to the strong side and just uses his strength, and he stays in the game. They're going to stay with their belldozer package.
Why not grind that clock out?
Yeah.
Right now, Oklahoma wants victory number 7. Next week, they are at West Virginia. Then they host Oklahoma State before finishing off the season at TCU. They have a great chance of going 10-2 this season and making a BCS bowl. And Bell, who had that huge game in the bowl victory last year over Iowa with 3 touchdowns. It's very close to another first down. And stay with us, fans, because our triple header will continue on Fox College Football. We have Southern Miss versus SMU, and that is coming your way next. SMU in the thick of that West race in Conference USA.
At some point out of this belldozer formation, they've got to throw the football. You got to be able to give the defense something to think about, not just run every time, even though they're having a lot of success.
They sure are. And he was more of a pro-style quarterback at Bishop Carroll High School. 5-star recruit, threw for over 6,000 yards and 70 touchdowns in high school. But when you are 6'6", 254, not too many defensive backs can take you down.
No, not at all. But at some point, because you can see 10 guys in the box to play the run, and then there's one guy outside playing man-to-man coverage on Kenny Stills. So at some point in time, you would think that they have to throw the ball to keep defenses honest out of this formation.
Well, he hammers his way forward for a short gain of about 2 yards. He already has 75 yards rushing, came in with only 88. They were using him mainly inside the 5-yard line. He has 10 rushing touchdowns this year. Second and 9. Well, we'll call it 8. To the left. He gets to the 30-yard line, a gain of 3. It will be 3rd down and about 7 yards to go for an Oklahoma first down. They have wound that clock down near the 7-minute mark when they get the next snap off.
Yeah, that's the biggest thing for them, is to keep that clock moving. Clock is on their side right now.
It went right down to the wire last year, but Baylor was able to pull it out, as RG3 threw for 479 yards and 4 touchdowns, including a 34-yarder to Terrence Williams with just 8 seconds left in the clock. Jones back, blitz on, and they finally get to him. Bryce Hager with the first sack for Baylor tonight.
Well, they bring two. They bring one inside that forces Brennan Clay to have to pick up inside, and then that leaves Hager free to come off the edge untouched. Watch Hager come off the edge. You can see Brennan Clay had to step up inside to pick up Sam Hall, the blitzing safety, and now Hager untouched for the sack.
And Hager, who had to replace the injured Rodney Chadwick, with a heck of a game, a career high 16 tackles. He had 15 against West Virginia. And here's that pooch punt towards the end zone, but it will go into the end zone. Tress Way, who's been averaging 42 and a half yards per boot. Baylor will have it at their 25 when we come back. 6:08 left. Oklahoma with a 16-point lead. A lot of great games on this Saturday. JC, your Heisman hopefuls.
Yeah, Colin Kine plays later on tonight against TCU. Going to be a huge, huge game. Braxton Miller having a great year. Kenyon Barner, my goodness. After watching him last week against USC, I think he might be the best running back in the country. And then obviously Mante Teo from Notre Dame. But I tell you what, Johnny Football, Johnny Manziel, might be playing his way right into that talk.
Texas A&M leading Alabama 29-17, the number one team in the nation. And who is the biggest threat to Heisman front runner Colin Kine? Well, A.J. McCarron, Kenyon Barner, Mante Teo, or Braxton Miller. Log on to Facebook.com/Fox Sports to cast your vote. Poll results will air later today, tonight in Fox College Football. Baylor has it first down at their 20. And Florence up close to a first down. That was a toss to Terrence Williams. Williams' sixth catch of the game. He has over 90 yards receiving, but he came in averaging 167.
Yeah, and other than the one big play, they've missed on a couple of others where he's been wide open down the field, and Nick Florence just hasn't been able to connect with him.
Seastrunk. He will get the first down as Tony Jefferson makes the tackle, but as much as I'm impressed with Tony Jefferson and Javon Harris, the two important safeties for Oklahoma, I love the work by the corners Hurst and Coleman and the job they've done closing out these terrific Baylor wide receivers.
Yes, very good man-to-man corners.
And they were step for step with Terrence Williams.
Tony Jefferson coming over, able to make that play. And at this point in the game, you know that the ball is going to come to Terrence Williams, so Tony Jefferson kind of cheating that way, able to get there in just enough time to break that pass up.
Williams with six catches for 91 yards. From the 40. Seastrunk. Even when he gains 2 yards, it's a wow-like 2 yards. You think you've got him contained in the middle of the field and he busts outside. 4.3 speed in the 40-yard dash. He also has a 42-inch vertical leap. Quick feet, exceptional athlete. You're on 3rd and 8. Crowd noise picks up here in Norman.
Play clock.
First charge timeout. Baylor, 30 seconds remaining.
Tonight's Whataburger, what a player, Landry Jones. 25 for 36, JC, 277 yards and 2 touchdowns.
Yeah, spread the ball all around, used at least 7 different receivers and made some big plays. See there to Sterling Shepard, and how about right at the end of the first half, a big 35-yard touchdown to Justin Brown. Landry Jones, what a player, definitely having a big game tonight.
There are his numbers, but I think he should take his entire offensive line out tonight to buy them a Whataburger. Maybe 4 each.
We could use a few of those ourselves up here.
Because Baylor has gotten to him only one time. Other than that, he has not been touched. It's 3rd down, 8 yards to go. Florence completes the pass and gets the first down. This time he went to Lanier Sampson away from Terrence Williams. And Aaron Colvin with the coverage and tackle.
They need to be in their super speed offense right now because the clock is working against them. They need to be ready to hike the ball as soon as they can.
Down 16, they need a score, go for a 2-point conversion, get a score and go for another 2-point conversion to tie this game up.
Yeah, they're not moving as fast as they should be.
And SMU will be hosting Southern Miss, part of our Fox College Football Saturday afternoon and evening of our triple header. Florence looking downfield, and it is broken up beautifully. Julian Wilson is a backup DB.
Just driving on the football. Does a good job of knocking it away. I tell you, this secondary, they play a lot of man coverage. Julian Wilson, Aaron Coleman, DeMontre Hurst, they've got three guys that can really cover. Allows them to do a lot defensively.
Short gain. They need to get to the 37-yard line for a first down. But one guy that Oklahoma's defense has taken away is Tevin Reese, who came in with 37 catches and 5 touchdowns. They hammer the middle again. Glasgow Martin, I don't know. Mark will be important. More importantly, the clock is inside 4 minutes to play now. Steve Fisiak, J.C. Pearson, Laura McKeeman with you in Norman, Oklahoma, as the Sooners trying to go 7-2 and 5-1 in conference play. Florence going for the home run. It is broken up at the goal line. DeMontre Hurst.
Boy, he's had a big game. Really challenged Terrence Williams all night long on short routes, deep routes. They just battle here for the ball on the go route, but DeMontre Hurst has done a tremendous job on Terrence Williams tonight.
Two veteran cornerbacks, Colvin and Hurst, 3-year starters each, combined over 300 tackles in great coverage. Play action. Florence again downfield, incomplete, intended for Sampson.
That's been the story all night. Baylor's had some opportunities to connect on some deep balls, and they just haven't been able to do it. Whether it's the wind or whatever it is, they just have not been able to connect, and that's at least three. We've seen a couple to Terrence Williams, that time to Sampson. They just haven't been able to connect on the go routes.
A season low 162 yards passing. Florence with the keeper, and Florence gets the first down and gets out of bounds. That's what's remarkable, the job that Oklahoma has done defensively on Nick Florence and the Baylor passing game. Baylor has gone for over 300 yards in each of their 8 games this season, until the Sooners, who have the number one pass defense in the Big 12. Florence with the out, incomplete.
Well, it's not just tonight. I mean, Oklahoma is the only Big 12 team that hasn't allowed a 300-yard passing game on them all year. Only 2 teams have thrown for over 200 yards, and only one wide receiver all year has caught over 100 yards in a game. So, I mean, it's not tonight. This defense, especially the pass defense, has played well all year.
Yeah, Kansas State and Notre Dame handed them losses because they ran the ball so well. Going deep, end zone. Broken up by Gabe Lynn.
Perfect coverage again. Gabe Lynn running stride for stride with Tevin Reese. Watch at the end, just does a great job, gets his head around, finds the ball, and then gets a hand up to knock it away, so any contact is incidental.
Here comes the 15th play of this drive, 3rd and 10. 4-man rush shown by Oklahoma. Florence will keep it and get it to about the 17-yard line. He'll still be about 5-6 yards shy of a first down.
I like Nick Florence. You talk about a competitor and a gamer. I mean, he's played his heart out tonight, running the football, making some plays with his arm. They've missed a few plays, but he's definitely given it all that he's got tonight, and he's not done yet.
Well, he needs to get it done right here on 4th down, as the clock winding down, nearing 2 minutes to go. He fires, and completes the pass for a first down. How about that? He goes to Clay Fuller, of all people. Clay only had two catches coming in.
Yeah, watch Clay Fuller, 23, just runs his arrow route outside, lets it clear out. Takes a big shot there from Javon Harris, but able to hang on to the ball.
On first down, they give it to Glasgow Martin. He is to the 6 and taken down by Harris.
And they've got to hurry. Clock is still running. They've got to hurry up. They're not moving nearly quick enough.
Play action. They try to get the fade in the end zone, but slipping in the end zone was a Baylor wide receiver. A reminder to our fans, our triple header continues as Southern Miss goes against SMU and Conference USA action. Right here, it's Oklahoma after win number 7. This is the 19th play of this drive. They run Seastrunk. Look at that move, and he will score. Well, he's going to be a special back in this league.
Yeah, he sure is, because he looked like he was stopped there. Fakes inside and gets all the defenders to jump inside, and then he uses quickness to get back outside and then scores the touchdown.
They must get the 2-point conversion to really have a chance to win this game. Then they would have to go for the onside kick, cover it, get the touchdown, and get a 2-point conversion again to tie the game. And Art Bryce
calls their final charge timeout of the half. 30 seconds.
Watch how quick Lake Seastrunk is. Look like he's dead to rights. Cuts inside. Gets Javon Harris, number 30, to bite on that inside fake. And then gets to the outside. Watch right here. Makes a guy miss, but good move right there. Freezes 3 Sooners inside. They lose leverage on him and get back to the outside and into the end zone.
Sometimes it's a good decision to follow your blockers. Other times, it's a good decision to ad lib if you've got those kind of skills.
Exactly. Not many people have those kinds of skills.
The SMU game just kicked off, and we will get it to our Conference USA fans as soon as this game ends. 1:26 left. Oklahoma with a record of 6-2 and 4-1 coming in. They're right behind Kansas State in the Big 12 standings. And Baylor was 4-4, 1-4, needing 2 more wins to become bowl eligible. Florence with an empty backfield. He'll have 3 receivers on the left and 2 on the right with Williams in the slot. And they're rolling over a safety to help out on Terrence, and now timeout called.
Prior to the expiration of the play clock, Baylor calls it second charge timeout. 30 seconds remaining.
I don't think they liked at all what Oklahoma's defense was showing them.
No, and they've got to get this 2-point conversion here, or it's still a 2-possession game, so might as well use them.
Oklahoma, it's surprising because Bob Stoops has had such great success here.
Yeah.
That their only 2 losses came at home to Kansas State, number 2 team in the nation, and number 4, Notre Dame.
Nick Florence has got to see if those safeties roll out again, that the quarterback draw is probably going to be wide open. And now they just go to. Yeah.
And Williams is interfered with, so Baylor will be given another chance to cut into that 10-point lead.
Pass interference, defense number 6. Half the distance to the goal, will reattempt the try.
Hurst and Colvin both have been very physical with Williams.
Yeah, and you can see just press coverage again, just an easy call to make. A lot of contact there, a lot of hands. But that's when you compete. DeMontre Hurst, like you said, has done a great job. Now they move Terrence Williams inside into the slot right there. So watch for him and try to get him the ball.
Florence keeps it, and I believe he gets in.
Yes.
Yes, the linesman said he did get in, so we've got ourselves an 8-point game. Baylor still has a chance.
Quarterback draw. Nick Florence has done a great job running the ball. You can see right there. Definitely gets in. Does a great job of just the yards after that contact. Javon Harris actually makes contact about the two, and Nick Florence still able to get in.
Reminder, fans, on our Fox College Football triple header, Southern Miss versus SMU coming your way next. Nick Florence was able to get the 2-point conversion after Lake Seastrunk scored the touchdown.
Now the onside kick.
And Kansas State, they are getting ready for their game on Fox against TCU. Kansas State with a 9-0 record, 6-0 in Big 12 play, and number 2 in the nation. And if Kansas State wins, they could move to number 1, because it looks like Alabama might lose to Texas A&M. The officials are replaying this.
And remember the new rules this year in college football, the onside kick rules, that if you pound the ball in the ground and take that high bounce, you've got to allow the receiving team to catch the ball. So don't expect that. Expect a short kick.
It is covered by Oklahoma, and Baylor with only one timeout remaining. All Oklahoma has to do is hold on to the football, and they will win it. And they bring in Blake Bell, where they stay with Landry Jones. Bell was out there. Now Jones is talking with his offense. We'll let our Conference USA fans know that SMU just scored a touchdown to go up in their game on Southern Miss. 7-0 that score.
And with one timeout, Baylor could not get the ball back unless Oklahoma fumbles it. So they're in their victory formation here.
Nick Florence with a valiant effort. But Oklahoma's defense, too much. I mean, the Baylor Bears went over 300 yards passing in every single game this year until tonight. They only threw for 172, and that is what Oklahoma's defense on the pass versus the pass has been allowing this year, 170 per game. And in a pass-happy Big 12, that's like, are you kidding me?
They've done a great job all year not giving up the big play. Mike Stoops, the defensive coordinator, back this year with his brother Bob. And they've simplified some things so the guys don't have the mental errors that they had last year. And defensively, they're playing very well. And like you said, especially in the Big 12, to put up those kind of numbers with all the high-powered offenses is even more impressive.
2 weeks ago, I was looking at the statistics, and I go, there are 7 of the 10 Big 12 teams averaging over 40 points per game. I think it's down to 5 teams now, but that's still half the pack. And of course, Oklahoma is now one of those, because they came in averaging 39.5, and they scored 42 in this one. And Bob Stoops, well, he has the record. He has the second most wins all time in Oklahoma history. Congratulations to Coach Stoops as he moves past Bud Wilkinson for second most all time. Barry Switzer, number 1 at 157. Kansas State owns the Big 12 right now at 9-0 and 6-0. They will be at TCU in a game you can watch on Fox. Nick Florence and Landry Jones meet at midfield. Congratulations to Oklahoma as they move the record to 7-2 and 4-5-1 in conference play. That's it from the Gaylord Family Memorial Stadium in Norman. with Oklahoma knocking off Baylor 42-34. Coming up next, a Conference USA matchup between Southern Miss and SMU. For J.C. Pearson and Laura McKeeman, I'm Steve Fizziak. You've been watching Fox College Football on Fox Sports Network.